Broadcast Network, Perry Miles here as the Bluefish return home for another series, this time against the York Revolution, the first time that these two teams will meet at the ballpark at Harbor Yard this season. Earlier in the year, the Bluefish claimed 2 out of 3 in York, Pennsylvania, and were able to come out with those victories in large part because of the runs that they were able to put on the board. This time around, they may not have as many offensive weapons because many of the players have departed. 2 of the outfielders and 1 of the infielders, and we will get to that during the pregame show. But the Bluefish are limited in the number of players that they are going to have available tonight. They have 10 positional players on the roster. The only one that has a backup is the starting catcher, Luis Rodriguez, for Angel Flores. Rodriguez is starting, and Angel Flores is going to be his backup. Everybody else is expected to play the entire 9 innings. There are several players on the Bluefish that have played outfield in case there is an injury, in case the players cannot go any further. The Bluefish are opting to go with these 9 for tonight, and the Bridgeport squad is hoping to get more as the week moves on. Today, it is Mr. Sean Hill, the right-handed pitcher and the former big leaguer, taking on the Bluefish's former big leaguer in their own right, Toby Stoner, a pair of right-handed pitchers who have been up and down this season. Stoner has a couple of victories on the year, but his ERA has been moving up. Meanwhile, Sean Hill has been mostly in the bullpen and had his first start of the year, his last outing, throwing 4 scoreless frames. When we come back on the Bluefish broadcast, we'll have starting lineups. We'll update you on the Bluefish transactions and then go to first pitch from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Game 1 of 4 in this series coming up. Memorial Day. It is a beautiful day. Come out to the ballpark or join me and my colleague RJ Garcia for the broadcast. Stay tuned. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Home entitled Coors Light Summer. It's a Coors Light Summer, hot babes all around. Backyard barbecues are where you'll be found. It gets pretty hot out, but it'll be all right because coolers are filled with ice cold Coors Light. You step outside, mini skirts galore. Beer garden for the ball game, that's what's in store. It's gonna be a scorcher, but there's hope in sight. Refreshment awaits, frost brewed Coors Light. Thank you.
Frost brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I call this little ditty America's pastime. Woo! Summer's here and it feels pretty nice. Baseball and hot dogs and refreshment on ice. Some games are early, some are at night. But there's always a beer man with ice cold Coors Light. He's the most reliable player in the game. All it takes is calling his name. So even if your team doesn't hit any dingers, you'll have frost brewed refreshment at the tips of your fingers. Thank you.
Frost brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I call this one best girlfriend ever. It had been a long day and an even longer week, so I headed toward the kitchen, refreshment I did seek. But after swinging open the fridge, I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold beverage, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys, it was time to hit the store, but stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the Real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the Real Yellow Pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the Real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
Baseball. Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to bridgeportbluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles here. The Bluefish and the York Revolution, the two-time champion, making their way to the ballpark at Harbor Yard for the first time this season. Last year, Bridgeport did not have a whole lot of success against the Revs. Just 4 wins and 14 losses, including for the first time in history, the Revolution winning the season series at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. 5 out of 9 games claimed by the two-time champion. But it is a vastly different lineup, not necessarily by the name, but by the way that they have performed this year relative to other years. And it all begins with Brandon Hovman. The center fielder leads off. Normally, it's the 2010 co-MVP, Scott Grimes, who's dealing with bone chip in his hand at this point. He's playing center field, Hovman is. And originally was on the Lancaster. Barnstormers just batted a .182. Lou Rodriguez is batting second and playing second. Andres Perez out of the lineup, the former member of the Fish. Normally he's playing second. Ramon Castro is at third base, batting third. That does not change. Michael Hernandez occupying right field, batting fourth. Chris Nowak is the first baseman, batting fifth. He's had quite a few home runs against the Bluefish this season. Bobby Kilty, the designated hitter and the former big leaguer, is the designated hitter, batting sixth. James Shanks is the left fielder, batting seventh. Danny Gonzalez from the Road Warriors a year ago, bats eighth. And Travis Scott, the catcher, an interesting story to say the least on how he got to the York Revolution, and we'll go over that story during the course of the broadcast. Those nine are supported by their starting pitcher in today's ball game. It is Sean Hill. 3 games, 1 start, an ERA of 12. But what's impressive is he had a complicated surgery last year. He had to remove a rib in order to recover from that surgery. Literally, one of his ribs had to be removed. And now he's trying to recover after making it to big league baseball for quite some time and having some success in the major leagues as well. The major leagues affiliates are hoping that he is able to be healthy, and it seems that he has more starts than he has bullpen appearances in his career. He's felt more comfortable out there as a starter as opposed to a guy out of the pen, which is why Andy Etchebarren has placed him in the starting rotation. His adversary tonight is Toby Stoner. An interesting story about Stoner is he's not had too much success, and as a result, we may see a few wrinkles tonight, which include a knuckleball, which he's been practicing on the side. His fastball, slider, changeup, and curveball are all pitches that he utilizes, but he's gotten hit around a little bit over his last 3 starts, giving up 19 earned runs in 15-plus innings as the right-hander hopes to succeed tonight. The former big leaguer is supported by this starting lineup. Pinar Jones is in center field, batting first. Pedro Lopez batting second, and playing second. Prentice Redmond bats third and plays right field. Luis Lopez is cleaning up and playing third base. Brock Peterson bats fifth and plays first base. Yeah. Luis Rodriguez, the catcher, batting sixth. The shortstop is Eddie Rogers, batting seventh. Peter Barrows is the designated hitter, batting eighth. He had one hit in each of his first two games for the Fish during the road trip. The University of Bridgeport graduate was in the Midwest last year and now playing for the team that he played for, or at least played with, at the University of Bridgeport. He played in this ballpark, hit a few home runs. Elliot Ayala, the newest member of the Bluefish who signed today, is the left fielder batting ninth as we introduce to you the second part of the broadcast team, and that is Mr. RJ Garcia. Mr. RJ, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great, Perry. How are you?
I'm doing okay. Now, 10 pieces, 10 positional players on this team. Elliot Ayala signed today, and now he's being put right into the lineup.
I mean, signed today, he must have been signed at 5 o'clock today. I mean, it wasn't an early morning thing, get situated. He was put right into the starting lineup, and that's just the dire need of a position player, period, for the Bluefish.
And there is only going to be one backup tonight, and that is the backup catcher in Mr. Flores, Angel Flores, who's been hitting quite well of late. But there are reasons why the Bluefish are down to this limited number of players. Colin DeLone, gone. Joey Gathright, gone. Ramon Vasquez, retired.
You know, that's just what happens when you're an independent minor league organization. You know, there's such a fluxion of players in and out of the system, and that's just the breaks, and you got to work with it. And talking to general manager Bob Goen today, and he was frustrated because nobody likes to try to scramble to try to fill roster spots. They want a nice set lineup that they is a go-to. But the reality of minor league baseball is this is what it is.
The York Revolution have had plenty of changes over the course of time, but they've been able to seemingly withstand all the issues that they have had. As a result, they are moving forward. They're 11-17 heading into today. They won yesterday against Southern Maryland, a squad that really pitches very well, especially from the starting rotation, which you saw last time that the Bluefish were in town.
Yeah, it's been the starting pitching has been the catalyst for this team and their winning ways. I mean, they've started to turn it up recently, and it's been due to starting pitching. Over the past 71 innings in 8 games, a 3.03 ERA as a whole as a team.
Now the Bluefish, they have struggled with their starting pitching with the exception of Paul Segura and Gilbert De La Vara. Toby Stoner still trying to figure out what he is going to be able to do. Raymar Diaz has had his ups, his downs. Isaac Hess, yesterday starting pitcher, really performed well in his first go-around. The second go-around, Long Island got to him. The third one, really, the Ducks took care of him.
Yeah, and it's been Hess and Stoner together have been kind of an Achilles heel. Bridgeport as a whole has given up the most home runs as a team, 32 home runs as a pitching staff. And Stoner and Hess have brought together 8-6 respectively of the 32.
The two stats that the Bluefish do not appreciate for the starting pitchers to lead the league in is extra base hits allowed, with Willie Upshaw was adamant about earlier in the year. And then the second stat that you brought up, the ability to get those two strike pitches in the appropriate spots to strike guys out or to eliminate the hits. The Bluefish have tried to adjust the situation. They've been unable to succeed in its execution. Let's take a quick look at the updated standings. The Long Island Ducks enter today's play 3.5 games ahead of the Bluefish. The Southern Maryland Blue Crabs 2 games behind Bridgeport and Camden, 6 games behind the pace set by Long Island, which means they're only a half game behind Southern Maryland. vast improvement first half last year from Camden compared with first half this year, and the Bluefish are going to have to deal with those teams moving forward. So when we come back on the Bluefish broadcast, we're going to have starting lineups one more time, and then first pitch from Bridgeport. You're listening to Perry Miles and RJ Garcia right here on BridgeportBluefish.com.
For the ideal place to meet before or after a show, game, or dinner, how about the perfect spot to unwind? Try the Blue Martini, Fairfield County's sophisticated gathering place in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. The atmosphere is pure, cosmopolitan. The light menu is as hip as the lounge itself. And our signature martinis, try it. The bartender hates you. You'll love it. Blue Martini, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking. Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish broadcast.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles here with RJ Garcia as the Bluefish and the North Revolution about to take center stage from the ballpark at Harvard Yard. Any thoughts about the way that the Bluefish have to execute?
Well, you know, Perry, if you could, looking back at the history of this season so far with the Bluefish offense, you'd have to say scoring runs is key. I mean, in baseball, that seems like an obvious point, but the discrepancy between wins and losses and the amount of runs that they score in each of those is unreal. And wins, 7.5 runs a game, and losses, 3.5 runs a game.
That's a big difference.
That is a big difference.
And the Bluefish, during the Long Island series, just to make your point, in their victories, they averaged 6.5 runs a game. In their losses, many fewer runs than that. Going to your point, the Bluefish need to put up some runs, although one of the main run producers no longer here, and Mr. Colin DeLome, he led the Bluefish in many offensive categories.
He's going to be a tough bat to fill in the lineup. As we mentioned earlier on a couple broadcasts here, he's been the catalyst of that lineup, period.
It's going to be very difficult for anyone to come up with these kind of numbers, but the Bluefish did add Barrels a few days ago to at least help the Bluefish out a bit in the outfield position. Today is his third straight day playing after competing in left field. He exhibited a tremendous arm, and the Long Island Ducks tested him, and it looked, from my angle from the press box, one throw went three-quarters of the way back in left field all the way to home plate on no hops. It was surreal. It almost looked the way they called it, the Long threw. The difference is the Long is much more. power ball.
But you can't argue, Peter's been doing well offensively, 2-for-6 with a double. I mean, he showed a little bit of resiliency in the box.
And the Bluefish and North Revolution get outside of the dugout box
for the singing of our national anthem. Ready
for the national anthem by Charlotte Massey. Our attention now to behind home plate.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rattling, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh,
Bridgeport Bluefish Broadcast Network, Perry Miles here. Just out of curiosity, how old do you think that person was from behind home plate? She looked no older than 7 or 8 years old. She did a great job.
Yeah, I was thinking more 4 or 5, to be honest.
Oh my gosh, that was a fantastic rendition. She hit all those octaves.
Yeah, she definitely some skills for a younger little girl there, and she can belt it a bit.
One person that has the skills that it takes to win in this game as well is Toby Stoner, the right-handed pitcher going to the hill. So far this season, it's been an up and down year. A couple of times he's pitched 7 innings or more. Other times, like the last 3 outings, he's lasted an average of 5 innings per start.
Stoner's going to need to control his fastball. You can see when he steps up and he's throwing it well, he's pinpoint accuracy on it, but if he leaves it a little bit up in the zone, you know, it's an average fastball at best.
And many of the hitters in this league can take care of average fastballs in the league. The last time the Bluefish had taken on the York Revolution, the Revs were the worst offensive team in the league, and they still have scored many fewer runs than the rest of the Atlantic League. Just 116 runs. That is 22 fewer than the team with the second least number in the league. And they have the lowest batting average in the Atlantic League as well. As we are underway, Brandon Hammond leads off for the Revolution. He is followed by Lou Rodriguez and Ramon Castro. 1, 2, and 3 in the order for the Revs. The center fielder steps up. He started the year off with the Lancaster Barnstormers. The Purdue University Davis takes a swing at a first pitch fastball and lines it to center field for a base hit. Hammond took the fastball towards the middle, and immediately a runner is on base.
Number one, nobody out. Second baseman.
Right off the chute, fastball. Stoner is a fastball throwing pitcher, and Hammond knew right away he's going to see a first pitch fastball and just turned on it.
Brandon Hammond has struggled this year, with the exception of his time in York, which has been limited to 15 at-bats. Here comes Lou Rodriguez as the first pitch dives low and inside. 1-0. Louis Rodriguez is behind home plate today. Luis Lopez is at the lip of the infield grass. The third, Eddie Rogers, short, Pedro Lopez over at second base. The next pitch twists inside. 2-0. Brock Peterson is over at first base. His bat's been hot, and his defense has been improving over the course of the year. Elliot Ayala, the newest member of the Fish, Kedar Jones, and Prentice Redmond from left to right in the outfield. The 2-0 from Stoner. Fastball right down the middle, 2-1.
That was a good confidence pitch for Stoner right there. He had to prove that he could get a fastball over there, and he pinpointed that corner.
There are some adamant fans in the low section as if they were at a football game or a soccer match. The pitch is inside, 3-1, and we will be hearing plenty from them today as they applauded the first strike thrown without contact in the game from Stoner.
Well, they couldn't have picked a better day to come out here and be energetic Bluefish fans. Perfect Memorial Day evening.
Oh, my. Temperatures in the 80s today. As a throw to first is not in time. Not that much humidity. Perfect conditions. And it felt like summertime for one of the few times in Bridgeport so far over the last couple of months. The 3-run from Stoner. He stalls and delivers. Pitches low. Ball 4. The York Revolution have the first couple of base runners on in the first to bring up Ramon Castro.
Stoner's going to need to start throwing some strikes. I know it's only been two batters, but early on, when you look at the numbers, York has the least amount of walks in the league by a lot. 62 walks is it before that one right there.
And much of that has been attributed to the fact that the Bluefish will either give up hits or not be able to throw the pitches where they absolutely need to in order to record more outs. They don't need strikeouts. They just need pop flies. Next pitch is stroked high in the air to center field. Not too deep. Kennard Jones moved back, then sprints forward and makes the play just to the right of center. A bluff tag by Brandon Hovman. He's got some good speed over there at second base. Runners at first and second with one man out.
And that's how it's done against the Revolution. Like I mentioned, make them swing the bat. They're not going to be taking pitches and looking to get on. They're looking to swing and put hits in play. And that's what you're going to have to do. Record outs, get it hit to where people are.
One of the guys on the Revolution that may make an all-star game appearance after making it in 2011 is the guy that's stepping up to the plate, Michael Hernandez. 8 jacks this year for the right-handed hitter, and he already has 2 against the Bluefish to throw to second, not in time. Have been playing a cat and mouse game with Stoner. He was ultimately concerned about the runner taking too much of a lead and perhaps breaking towards third with one man out.
I think he mistimed his jump there, or Stoner's move to the plate, because it looked like he started taking off before Stoner even tried to make a move to the home.
The one out toss, fastball inside, 1-0. We said earlier in the broadcast he may decide to mix in a little bit of a knuckler. He had been working on that during his side sessions in Long Island. The 1-0. Off-speed pitch on the outside corner. Call strike, 1-1.
Nice pitch by Stoner, especially with 2 runners on. Don't want to be giving up a single here. That's going to lead to possibly a run. Looking for a ground ball, trying to keep the ball low.
The 1-1. Swung and grounded to short. Fielding is Rogers. He throws the 2-1 onto first. Double play. Good call.
Right on cue. Stoner gets the pitch he's looking for, and the Bluefish are heading to the bottom half of the first.
No score after one base hit. Only one runner left on. End of a half. No score. You're listening to Perry Miles and RJ Garcia here on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Celebrate the game. Celebrate the passion.
Baseball is different in a lot of ways, where the history of the sport means so much. And it's something we should never forget. And I think the Hall of Fame has a way of reminding us.
Anytime that I've visited it, just I'm like a little kid.
You people at the Hall of Fame have done a great job of preserving the history of the game.
Celebrate the game. Celebrate the passion. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game,
Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Number 17, center fielder, Kennard Jones.
We bring you back to Bluefish Baseball, the Bluefish broadcast. Perry Miles here with RJ Garcia. The inning-ending double play leads to the second start for Sean Hill on the mound. The last time he just gave up two base runners in four innings of work, shutout baseball. The first pitch is smoked foul to the left side, off the facade, and ricochets right near the first row of seats and nearly hit a woman that was not even looking at the ball, deflecting out there. No balls and one strike. Hill deals again. The next pitch is inside. One ball and one strike.
Kennard Jones, the speedster, batting 311, 19 RBIs on the year, five doubles, a triple.
The 1-1 swung on and poked into left field, but playable for James Shanks, who corrals one away on the F7. Let's get to the rest of the outfield defense and the infield defense. Shanks, Hovman, Michael Hernandez, left to right.
Ramon
Castro, Danny Gonzalez, Lopez, Rodriguez, Chris Naughton. The only difference is that Andres Perez is not playing second. It's Mr. Rodriguez. And Travis Scott is behind home plate for Sean Hill.
Now with Gathright departing and DeLone, Pedro Lopez moves up to the two-hole.
Next pitch, fastball on the outside corner, no balls and one strike. Not to mention, Kennard Jones moves into the starting center field role. Normally, he was playing left field, but he played center when he was with the Newark Bears. He also played that a little bit last year with Long Island. The 0-1 is low, one ball and one strike.
Lopez, much better hitter against righties, 333 and 51 at-bats compared to a 148 and 27 at-bats versus lefties.
1-1, slider on the outside corner, one ball and two strikes. Lopez is dealing with a sore hand. He's been dealing with that for the last week and a half. And it has given him a little bit of an issue with regards to the top hand. The next pitch just bends low. Lopez looking back at the home plate umpire Ronnie Whiting. No call made on the strike. Two balls, two strikes.
Boy, he wanted to go around there, Perry. He wanted to ring him out, but it might have dove just a little low.
In basketball, they call that a pump fake. Two balls and two strikes. Pitch chopped on the ground to the right side. Angles towards second. Rodriguez flips it with the glove and makes the play. Two outs in the frame, 4-3. A dazzling moment from Lou Rodriguez.
That's one of the better plays you're going to see here on a slow grounder. No choice but to go from glove to glove. And Pedro Lopez might be smirking walking back to the dugout here because he knows he's gotten a fair share of batters on that same play.
It's only happened a few times this year in the Atlantic League, but you see that on SportsCenter almost every week or two with the flip of the glove, and usually makes top five plays for the night. The two-out toss to Prentice Redmond is outside, one ball. No strikes. Redmond riding a 27-game on-base streak.
He's definitely been putting in work. Survived an 0-for-4 effort with a walk to keep that on-base streak alive.
The 1-0 fastball glides to the inside corner. One ball, one strike. He leads the Atlantic League in doubles with 13. He picked up one in yesterday's contest. The 1-1. Slips outside, two balls and one strike.
Redmond having a nice year, 312 batting average, a career 280 hitter in the minors.
Prentice Redmond was within an inch, an iota of getting to the big leagues. He was dominating in Fresno before he had the 100-game suspension as the pitch is sent foul into the Bluefish dugout. Two balls and two strikes. That was way back, 2010. Fresno was batting 298. double-digit home run, 60-plus RBI, and unfortunate news for him as he swings and misses strike three on the off-speed pitch to Prentice Redmond. A 1-2-3 inning for Bridgeport in their half of the first. No score from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. You're listening to Perry Miles and RJ Garcia here on BridgeportBluefish.com.
All right, man. Screwdriver, the golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Road fork, tuning fork, wood fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. One of those pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open a new Miller Lite Punch top can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less clog. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, foot fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, the chopsticks from replacing with the Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter, and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor.
We bring you back to Bluefish Baseball on the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles here. The Bluefish against the York Revolution, game number one of this four-game series, and slugger Chris Nowak steps up to the plate. He's fouled by Bobby Kelty and James Shanks, 5, 6, and 7 in the
number
York order.
First baseman Chris Nowak.
Nowak this year has had a number of home runs against the Bluefish in that three-game set as he stands in a tall right-handed bat. As he has an even stance and waggles it up top. Pitcher set, lifts his leg and deals. First pitch slides away, one ball and no strikes.
Nowak, like you mentioned, the two home runs against the Fish last time they met. That's also with a .417 batting average, a double and four ribbies.
Monster power hitter, the 1-0, slides to the inside corner, one ball and one strike.
There's a nice pitch by Stoner right there, working side to side on the plate, outside, inside, keeping him off balance a bit.
Light fixtures on at the ballpark, evening baseball is here. The 1-1, another outside pitch, this time away from the corner. Two balls and one strike. Luis Lopez close to the third baseline. The shortstop, Eddie Rogers, playing more towards third. Everyone else is slightly shifted further towards the middle as the next one finds the inside corner. Nowak a little bit confused about the call. He thought it was inside. Two balls and two strikes.
Stoner's been going back and forth, like I mentioned. Let's see if he comes back with back-to-back inside pitches where he's throwing strikes.
2-2. Chop foul on the ground, third base side. And one of the fans in the front row just bobbled the ball, even with the glove, and continued to spike his hand towards the dugout top.
Good pitch by Stoner, just as I mentioned, on the inside half, broke back in. And you could see that Nowak was waiting for it and pulled around early on that.
This is Nowak's second year with the Revolution Ball Club, and in the first year, boy, did they have a number of sluggers to replace him as the pitch is sent out to the left center field. Pretty well hit, but Kennard Jones reaches back in front of the Budweiser sign, makes the play for the first out of the top of the second inning.
That was hit real well, and Jones got a good beat on that right off
number
the bat and was able to track down that line drive
Bob
going
Kilty
towards left center field.
Brings up Bobby Kilty. What an interesting story. Six different professional baseball teams taking chances on him, most notably with the Minnesota Twins. And Kilty, originally born in the state of California, as the next pitch is on the outside corner. For a call, strike, no balls and one strike. Teammates with Corey Thurman, who's now a member, well, he has been a member for the York Revolution for quite some time. The 0-1. Slides outside, one ball and one strike.
But Kilty, as you mentioned, now he's an independent ball with the Revs. And 14 at-bats, only four games, but he seems to have found a nice little place.
Next pitch, fastball outside. Two balls and one strike. Number of stories about Bobby Kilty, the left-handed hitter, batting against the right-hander Toby Stoner, the 2-1. Swung on and foul tipped into the glove. Two balls and two strikes.
Stoner's got him right where he wants him. 2-2 pitch. Pretty much off balance in the batter's box, this righty-lefty battle.
The 2-2. Swung on and missed. Strike three. High fastball from Toby Stoner. Mentioned during the pregame, you mentioned during the first couple of moments of the ball game, it all came down to establishing the fastball. Well, Stoner set the stage
number
for that.
12, left fielder,
that was
James
a good pitch
James.
There, and had him guessing. He threw a couple curveball for strikes, had a little bit of problem locating that fastball, but gets that one over and just behind his Kilty for the strikeout.
James Shanks, arguably one of the biggest disappointments this year for York, as the first pitch is outside, one ball and no strikes. James Shanks last year was a prodigious power hitter, 20-plus homers and 70, 80 RBI. He was a beast at the plate. Not to mention he played a solid left field for the ball club. He stands with the open stance, the 1-0, bends inside to the corner, one ball and one strike. Shanks this year just at 189, four homers, 16 RBI entering today.
And that's 169 against right-handed pitchers as well.
Luis Lopez just establishing his space on the third base side as he waits for Shanks. The 1-1, pitch on its way, outside, two balls and a strike.
Still has the power numbers though, Perry. Four home runs, 16 RBIs, second on the team with those 16 RBIs.
Two balls and one strike. Stoner, former New York Met, a couple of stints up there. But now he's in independent baseball, hoping to get back to the bigger stages of baseball. The 2-1 from the righty. Fastball glides to the outside corner again. Ronnie Whiting calls two balls, two strikes.
Another good pitch by Stoner, really making each one of his tosses count.
Another offering from Stoner. This time it's pulled down the third base line. It kicks to the tarp. Two balls and two strikes. Number of players have made their way out of the Park City. We mentioned about Joey Gathright and Colin DeLome. They made it to affiliated baseball. Ramon Vasquez retired this year. The 2-2 swung on and served out to right field. Prentice Redmond sprints back. He has room and makes the catch. For the final out of the inning, we'll continue with more of the transactions this year as the Atlantic League continues to move forward while players change destinations. 1-2-3 inning in the second. No score from Bridgeport. You're listening to Perry Miles and RJ Garcia here on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
If I die young, bury me in
Bluefish baseball continues in the bottom half of inning two. The Bluefish and the York Revolution. The first pitch is on the outside corner for a called strike. No balls and one strike. Luis Lopez followed by Brock Pearson and Luis Rodriguez. 4, 5, and 6. The 0-1 from Sean Hill is on the outside corner. No balls, two strikes.
Luis Lopez, a pretty patient batter at the dish. Tied for Atlantic League lead, 23 walks this season. A professional hitter in all respects.
Approaching 2,100 hits, the pitch is grounded softly towards short. Handled by Gonzalez on the move, and he throws to first, one away. 6-3 on the putout as Lopez goes back to the dugout. Brock Pearson moves forward. He's been the hottest member of the Bluefish with the number of hits that he's had over the season and over his time. And yesterday came up with a two-run homer that at the time gave the Bluefish an early lead.
It was huge for Brock to get going like this. I mean, over the last six games, he's batting 400, and that includes those three games against the Ducks. Four games, I should say. 4-11 with a home run and those four RBIs.
The right-hander Hill lifts and deals. First pitch slides outside, one ball and no strikes. Sean Hill reached the major leagues at the age of 23, making the jump from Double-A Harrisburg to Montreal. He is one of the few Canadian players to play for both major league teams at the time as the pitch is swung on and missed.
It's a pretty interesting stat right there, that fact about Sean Hill. And the fact of the matter is, he can't play for the Expos anymore.
Correct. He did play for the Expos and drafted by Montreal back in 03, though, or rather 2000. The pitch is roped foul to the left side. One ball, one strike. He made his debut with the Expos in 03. Eventually played with Toronto, Washington, San Diego. 44 major league starts to his credit and was also a competitor in the Athens Olympic Games.
That's pretty special if you could say you're on an Olympic roster.
1-2, fastball outside, two balls and two strikes. Many times in hockey, what the NHL will do is they'll make sure that there's a couple of weeks time off to allow the players to compete for their respective countries during the wintertime. In baseball, that may not have been the case a few years ago. As a matter of fact, for this coming Olympics, they have banned both baseball and softball. The 2-2 is served high in the air down the right side. Chris Nowak drifts into foul ground and makes the play near the warning track, two away.
So, banned it, Perry, or just decided to go elsewhere for this?
They decided to ban it for 2012. They're not going to do anything with baseball or softball. They're hoping to get it back for 2016. But you never know. If you're going to have it during the summertime, you're not going to have the big league ball players, and many of the AAA ball players are probably not going to compete. They want to get to the big leagues just as badly as the rest of the players do. Two out tosses over the middle, no balls, one strike, or improve their lives in ways that have not been influenced at all. They're hoping to move up in the world. The 0-1, chopped on the ground, foul to the third base side, no balls and two strikes.
Luis Rodriguez, fifth year now on the team for Bridgeport, started back in 08. He's been playing pro ball since 1994, Perry.
The 0-2, chopped on the ground, too short. A high hop that's handled on two by Danny Gonzalez, and he throws to first in time for the final out of the frame. No runs, no hits, no one left on. At the end of two, Bridgeport and York are scoreless. You're listening to Perry Miles and RJ Garcia here on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Where history comes alive 7 days a week for the next year. Educational programs and summer history camps.
The commercials are out too.
270
Beach Road in Perry. It's a cool, bright summer, hot babes all around. Backyard barbecues are where you'll be found. It gets pretty hot out, but it'll be all right because coolers are filled with ice-cold Coors Light. You step outside, mini skirts galore. Be your garden for the ball game, that's what's in store. It's going to be a scorcher, but there's hope in sight. Refreshment awaits, frost-brewed Coors Light.
Thank you. Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I call this little ditty America's Pastime. Woo! Summer's here and it feels pretty nice. Baseball and hot dogs and refreshment on ice, Some games are early, some are at night, but there's always a beer man with ice-cold Coors Light. He's the most reliable player in the game. All it takes is calling his name, so even if your team doesn't hit any dingers, you'll have Frost Brewed Refreshment at the tips of your fingers. Thank you.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I call this one best girlfriend ever. It had been a long day and an even longer week, so I headed toward the kitchen, refreshment I did seek. But after swinging open the fridge, I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold beverage, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys, it was time to hit the store, but stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Hello, my name's Joe Bateman. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. I have Joy Gaston.
Bluefish baseball returns for inning number 3. The Bluefish and the Revolution are scoreless here tonight as Toby Stoner waits, lines, and deals. The right-hander sends one outside, 1-0. Danny Gonzalez, Travis Scott, and Brandon Hovman, 8-9-1 due up in the order. As the next pitch is on its way, swung on and served out to left field, not too deep. Ayala breaks forward, moves back, and backpedals close to the track to make the play for out number 1. Counts as an F7 on the score sheet.
So this is a pretty historic date for the rivalry of York and Bridgeport. The 100th meeting all time right here at the ballpark at Harbor Yard.
And the York Revolution have had such good success at their stadium, Sovereign Bank Stadium. Bridgeport has had most of the success here at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, which is why York, for the first time in their franchise history, won the season series a year ago. The 1-0 is swung on and sent high in the air to shallow center field. Eddie Rogers backpedaling. He's called up by Kennard Jones. The center fielder makes the play just behind the shortstop position on the grass. Two away.
And going back to that, when the Revolution come here to Bridgeport, they're just 16-31 against the Bluefish, opposed to the Bluefish going there, and they're 38-14 against the Fish.
And for anyone that has never been to Sovereign Bank Stadium before, the stadium is conducive for home run and doubles hitters. The one pitch is inside, 1-0.
Part of the reason why the Revolution leading the league in home runs as a team.
The 1-0. Bunted foul to the third base side. Excellent idea by Hadman. He's not a great power hitter, but he's got great speed, which is why he's at the top of the lineup and playing in center.
Anything to get on base. Stoner starting to get into a little bit of a groove here the past, I'd say, 4 to 5 batters, and anything to break it up.
He's retired 7 in a row. The 1-1 is a slug bunt towards the third base side, but angles fell. Ball and 2 strikes. Luis Lopez was not sold the first time he bunted. He wasn't sold on the second time he bunted either, as he stayed in the same position.
We'll see if he'll be moving forward here with 2 strikes. Chances are they're going to take the bunt off, but who knows if the bunt was really on or Hevman was just trying to make a play.
The 1-2 is slapped towards third, handled by Lopez. He has to rush it across, and he just beats Hevman in time for the final out of the inning. He can fly down the first baseline. It took him 3.2 seconds down the first baseline. But the Bluefish are out of the inning after a 1-2-3. End of 2.5. No score from Bridgeport. You're listening to Perry Miles and RJ Garcia here on BridgeportBluefish.com. Welcome to
special screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Grill fork, tuning fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing, a smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with. Sorry, Alan. Drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant. A motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. A spark plug. A domino. A house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Advertising with the Bridgeport Bluefish is a sure way to hit a home run in your community. Since 1998, nearly 3 million fans have spun the turnstiles at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Supporting their local team and Fairfield County's local businesses sponsoring the Bluefish is just the right thing to take your business in the direction you want. The proof is in the numbers. More than 70% of Bluefish partners renew their sponsorships annually. And the best part is, there are tons of ways to get involved. Billboards, in-game promotions, giveaways, Fish Vision video board ads, radio spots, and much more. If the economy is sinking your business, it's time to get swimming.
Bluefish baseball returns. The first pitch is outside. One ball and no strikes in the bottom of the third. If you would like to sponsor the Bluefish, you can call up a ticket sales representative at 203-345-4800 or talk to one of the sales representatives as the next pitch is outside. Two balls and no strikes. Eddie Rogers, Peter Barrels, Elliot Ayala, 7, 8, and 9 in the order for the Fish. The 2-0 swung on and bounced on the ground foul to the third base side. It may have even hit one of the fans in the chest on the fly.
Going back to that play, I can't get over. I didn't get a chance to interject in there that Louis Lopez play over at third. What a cannon off of that backhand.
The 2-1. Grounded sharply down the third baseline. It is a fair ball and rolls towards the bullpen, well away from James Shanks. Motoring onto second base and going halfway around before stopping was Eddie Rogers. It did not look like Shanks was going to take that long to get the ball in, but he did, and it nearly resulted in a three-bagger instead of a two, which is where Eddie Rogers stays. Second base, nobody out. To bring up Peter Barrows.
First hit for the Bluefish tonight, fittingly to Eddie Rogers, who tore up the Revolution at Sovereign Bank Stadium, 7-for-10 with 3 doubles and 6 RBIs.
The 6 RBI was one during one game in which he picked up the most RBIs that he's had all season. And during an interview earlier in the year, he said he's never gotten a game where he had 6 RBI. The most that he remembers was 5 ribbies as Peter Barrels moves forward. The former University of Bridgeport player has played in the American Association his past. His dad actually works in the state of Connecticut as a security guard at Mohegan Sun. And he was a formidable force at the University of Bridgeport, batting well into the 300s. And according to the SID over there, the pitch is right on the outside corner, no balls and one strike, who just so happens to be the scorekeeper for the Bluefish, Chuck Sadowski. He mentioned that he was a prolific hitter who had some great pop.
I mean, it's 6'4", 205. That's a solid built athlete right there, especially an outfielder, and still at only 24 years old.
The 0-1, swung and chopped right to third. Handled by Castro, he looks the runner back and throws to first in time. Eddie Rogers must stay put at second base, and it brings up Elliot Ayala after the 5-3.
So here's Willie Upshaw inserting the two new guys. I know Barrows has played two games prior, but back-to-back, 8-9 in the lineup, and we mentioned the success that the Fish have had when they're scoring runs, but this is the first time the lineup's really been shaken up.
And the reason why the Bluefish have had to shake it up is because of the departures of three players over the last 4 days. It's very difficult to replace players after they've departed from teams, especially the talented Colin DeLome. Let's not forget about the leadoff capabilities of Joey Gathright. And, of course, Ramon Vasquez, who is a versatile infielder, could play second, third, short. He can play all those positions. The one-out toss is a jam shot sent to the left side. Castro charges in and throws to first in time. The third baseman has recorded the first two outs of the third with Eddie Rogers moving to third base.
Slow roller right there. Nice play by Ramon Castro. MLB veteran. He knew exactly what to do with that ball. Charging up one play. Rogers is going to get third base as it is. and you got two outs. So it's going to take a base knock to score Rodgers and not a sacrifice fly.
Colin DeLome was the team's leader in RBI, but the guy that was second in line is the guy that's stepping up to the plate right now, Kennard Jones. 19 RBI leads the team at this point among active players. Pitches lifted foul, no balls and one strike.
You know, talking to bench coach Terry McGriff about the timely hitting, and it's not that the Bluefish haven't been able to get runners on base. It's coming up with these key hits in key situations that really move things along.
The 0-1. Fastball right down the middle. No balls and two strikes. One hit for each side, no score. Bottom of the third. A 7:05 first pitch from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Memorial Day Monday. Bluefish will have three more games at home in this series as the pitch is grounded on one hop to second, where Lou Rodriguez records the out. 5-3 on the rifle. No runs. One base hit. Eddie Rodgers stranded in scoring position at the end of three. We're still scoreless at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Anything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T. Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you search with the real yellow pages, you get more than a contractor. You get a whole new curb appeal. It's not just getting directions to a dry cleaner with YP.com. It's rescuing an old favorite from the back of the closet. And it's more than finding a locksmith with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting to sleep in your own bed. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
Looking for the ideal place to meet before or after a show, game, or dinner? How about the perfect spot to unwind? Try the Blue Martini, Fairfield County's sophisticated gathering place in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. The atmosphere is pure cosmopolitan. The light menu is as hip as the lounge itself. And our signature martinis, try it. The bartender hates you. You'll love it. Blue Martini, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Bluefish Baseball. In the top half of the fourth inning, Toby Stoner has thrown three scoreless frames and has allowed one hit. So has Sean Hill. As the first pitch is on its way from Stoner, it's pulled to the first base side. It is a foul ball. It just dribbled down the first base side as Lou Rodriguez was bidding for an extra base hit. Peterson dove but could not get there. The first base umpire for today is the crew chief of the staff, Mark Facto. He made the call as the ball veered to the right of the first base bag. No balls in one strike to Lubomirovitz Rodriguez. The pitch is in there, low. One ball, one strike.
Lou Rodriguez, first year.
That's why I call him Lou. His first name, quite a bit long. The 1-1, fastball low. Two balls, one strike. Go ahead.
Yeah, no question about it. Lou is much easier, I'll tell you that. But first year as player coach, only the second one in Rev's history as a player coach.
Linoel Polanco was the initial one, the 2-1. Swung on and lifted high in the air to right field, not too deep, as Prentice Redmond jogs towards his left and makes the play for out number one. Linoel Polanco is a former member of the Fish. A few years back, Lou Rodriguez has never been involved with Bridgeport.
Now that's nine straight batters for Stoner, who he is retired since the walk to Ramon Castro in the first inning.
The one out pitch from the right-hander slides outside, one ball and no strikes.
And here's Castro right now looking to extend a six-game hitting streak.
Castro, the third baseman, with a closed stance. Bluefish expecting especially on the left side, to pull as the next pitch is right in there for a strike. Castro stretches himself out as he was in disbelief. Castro was thrown all over the place in the lineup last time against the Bluefish. One time he batted seventh in the order, one time he batted third. It was almost like a puzzle, just jumbling it up. 1-1, swung on and lifted to the left field, not too deep, charging forward, making the catch. On the move, Elliot Ayala for the second out of the inning.
Ayala read that perfect, and immediately, as I have not seen any of his game to this date, he's got some good speed and a good first step out there in left field.
The Somerset Patriots had him since 2006 before he came to the Bluefish. They did not have any room for him on their roster, but he is one of the more versatile players in the league and play out every outfield spot, and he can play the middle infield positions. The two-out tosses outside, one ball, no strikes. And I'm sure he's played third base in his career, the only three positions really that hasn't played. It's first base, catch, or pitch. Many times the first baseman needs to be taller than most of the others. The 1-0 is served foul to the right.
And at 5'6", I'm not sure he's going to cut it there over at the one bag.
Tell you one thing. I'm 5'6". Never could I imagine someone my height playing first base.
It really makes it difficult, especially for the left side of the infield. You need a big target to throw there. You're coming with some heat.
1-1 is way inside and low. Two balls and a strike. Got a 55-footer.
You're trying to heave one over there, and if you could see a big target there, a big blue shirt like the Bluefish have on today, that makes it all that much easier if you're trying to guess which, you know, play, which area to throw it to. It's going to make it tough.
Two balls and one strike. Glove down, leg, lift, pitch, swung on and missed. Another off-speed pitch from Stoner, 2-2.
Stoner really in the groove right now. He's working his off-speed and his fastball almost together in unison, back and forth, kind of rocking the boat.
The 2-2 on its way, way inside a curve. You could tell from this vantage point that the curve was going to slip up a bit. He's been working on all of his pitches, but one that we might see often when hitters are behind in the count, maybe a knuckler. The 3-2, inside out, Pope foul down the right side, out of play.
He fought that one off pretty good. I'm not sure if he's going to revert to that knuckleball that he's just trying out, as he's got his first and secondary pitch pretty much working well.
And as long as they are effective, what need is there for any more than just the two pitches? Go with what's your best.
And that's the truth.
Never get beat with your third or fourth best pitches. The 3-2 is smacked into left center field. That hits the gap. That is a base hit as it rolls towards the All-American waist sign. Moving over to second base and stopping there, Michael Hernandez with a two-out double to bring up Chris Nowak.
You could see where that power comes from Michael Hernandez, who leads the league in those home runs, like you've mentioned, with eight. And right there, he found the gap with ease and two-hopped the wall.
Chris Nowak is 0-4-1 with a fly ball to center field as he moves into the batter's box. If Nowak reaches, Bobby Kilty would get an opportunity. He waits in the on-deck circle. Two men out. Stoner, a right-hander against the righty Nowak. Pitch on its way. Check swing, went through the zone. No balls and one strike. Wind drifting out a little bit towards left field. Not going to play much of an impact today. Ballpark at Harper Yard does not play to the hitter's advantage for the most part. The 0-1. Swung on and served out to left field, but Elliot Ayala moves in a couple of steps and makes the play for the final out of the inning. A nice frame for Ayala and the Fish. A couple of fly ball outs. One base hit for the Revolution, but nobody scores. End of three and a half. No score from Bridgeport. You're listening to Perry Miles and RJ Garcia here on BridgeportBluefish.com.
At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
I'm gonna marry the night. I won't give up on my life.
Advertising with the Bridgeport Bluefish is a sure way to hit a home run in your community. Since 1998, nearly 3 million fans have spun the turnstiles at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Supporting their local team and Fairfield County's local businesses sponsoring the Bluefish is just the right thing to take your business in the direction you want. The proof is in the numbers. More than 70% of Bluefish partners renew their sponsorships annually. And the best part is, there are tons of ways to get involved. Billboards, in-game promotions, giveaways.
Bottom of the fourth inning is here. Quickly, the eight pitches thrown by Sean Hill as he gets ready for another inning of work. So far, three scoreless. Pedro Lopez stares at a fastball in the outside corner. No balls and one strike.
Pedro Lopez, like I mentioned earlier, up into the two hole.
The next pitch dives low. One ball and one strike.
I think he might be a little out of place there without being next to his up-the-middle mate, Eddie Rogers. They've got some type of chemistry working together in winter ball.
The 1-1, slider away, two balls and one strike.
This past season, as I was trying to say, Rogers and Lopez together up the middle developed a little bit of that chemistry.
The 2-1 on its way. Right-hander deals, pitches a fastball high, 3-1. Well, many of the players go to winter ball. One of the interesting stories about winter ball was about today's starting catcher, Travis Scott. He went to Australia for winter ball. The 3-1 is chopped on the ground towards short as Danny Gonzalez corrals and throws to first, one away on the 6-3. Just moved in a couple of steps before he delivered the baseball and brings up Prentice Redman. Travis Scott went to Australia to play Winter League Baseball, and one of the York Revolution former sales associates moved from York to go down to Australia. She was a connection for the Revolution, so Mark Mason, the pitching coach, called up the Australian team that the two worked for as the pitches swung on and missed. No balls and one strike. And she advised Travis Scott that he could play in the States. And Mark Mason told the contact, this former sales associate, give me his number. Give me Travis Scott's number. They talked. They talked again when Travis Scott went back to the States. Next pitch is inside. One ball and one strike. And the rest is history. Travis Scott signed with the Revolution. 1-1. Slider away. Two balls and a strike.
And behind the dish today as we speak. So it's good to see him playing. And, you know, there's a means to everybody's end. You know, you can be found anywhere and find yourself on a team.
The 2-1. Fastball upstairs. Three balls and a strike. The York Daily Record, one of the main newspapers in the lower Susquehanna Valley, they said that Salvador Paniagua is typically the starter. He's going to get all the starts against lefties and some starts against righties. He would start against most of the lefties. The pitch is lifted in the air to left center, but it's caught by the shortstop just shy of the outfield as Danny Gonzalez made the play. Looked a little bit harder hit than I originally thought.
Yeah, then a jam shot off of the bat of Redman and brings them 0-2 on the day, still looking to extend that on-base streak.
Probably counts more as a P6 than an L6. As Luis Lopez stands in, he's 0-1 today. A 6-3 putout for Lopez in the second inning. The third baseman stands in against the righty, and another pitch swerves outside. One ball and no strikes.
Lopez had a nice series against the Ducks this past weekend. 5-13, 7 walks he drew. 7.
And he's one of the Atlantic League leaders in that category. Patience at the plate is what the Bluefish preach. The 1-0. Swung on and served foul to the right side. One ball, one strike. By far, they lead the Atlantic League in total number of walks per game. And they average about 5 a game.
Just shy, 148 total walks in those 30 games. 4.9, like you said, just shy of 5.
The 1-1, fastball outside.
as opposed to York bringing up the rear in walks, 2.2 walks a game.
That is not a lot of walks. But the Revolution were accustomed to being aggressive hitters. The fastball is outside, three balls and one strike. That was their identity. Swinging early in the count, swinging at pitches that they were accustomed to hitting. Whatever they feel comfortable with, fastballs inside. Another walk for Luis Lopez in the season. It's only his first one tonight, but soon enough he's going to be tired of getting walks. And gotta hit a little bit.
Pending what Brian Bergamy is going to do today for Camden, Luis Lopez is in first place.
First baseman, number 23.
Brock Peterson moves in. Top fly, foul out to first.
But to put it in perspective for York as a team taking walks, they're 30 walks behind the team that is in front of them in second to last place, Sugarland. That's 30 walks.
Sugarland has a different philosophy from those other teams in the league as the pitch is stroked into shallow left center field. On the move, the captain of the outfield, Mr. Havman, makes the play. The center fielder makes the catch for the final out of the frame. No runs, no base hits, a runner left on, end of four, no score. You're listening to Perry Miles and RJ Garcia here from the ballpark at Harbor Yard in Bridgeport, Connecticut. We'll be right back after this.
Hey, Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team, including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week, stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the Major League experience.
Advertising with the Bridgeport Bluefish is a sure way to hit a home run in your community. Since 1998, nearly 3 million fans have spun the turnstiles at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Supporting their local team and Fairfield County's local businesses sponsoring the Bluefish is just the right thing to take your business in the direction you want. The proof is in the numbers. More than 70% of Bluefish partners renew their sponsorships annually. And the best part is, there are tons of ways to get involved. Billboards, in-game promotions, giveaways, Fish Vision video board ads, radio spots, and much more. If the economy is sinking your business, it's time to get swimming with the Bluefish. To join the Bluefish team now, call any of our front office sales representatives at 203-345-4800 for more information.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't...
Bridgeport Bluefish baseball shifting to the top half of the fifth inning. Two teams are scoreless as the first pitch is on its way from Toby Stoner. Swung on and missed by Bobby Kilty. No balls and one strike. Kilty, Shanks, and Danny Gonzalez. Many fans in the New York City area remember Kilty back when he was a member of the Minnesota Twins. The 0-1 is stroked high in the air to deep right center field. Redmond on a dead sprint towards the gap and makes the play on the move for the first out of the inning. Kilty got some great wood on that pitch. but he was unable to knock it to the gap. And not to mention, Kilty's had some great success in the past. Well, in this league, he at least got a home run last game in the 3-2 Revolution win against a very tough Southern Maryland squad.
That he did. Eduardo Molin started the season 16 and a third innings scoreless and gives up the tater.
He was fantastic this year, Eduardo Molin, against the Bluefish. And you wondered, or many people wondered, if Eduardo Molin would take over the job for Jim Edward, and the one-out pitch is swung on and missed by Shanks.
Shanks stepping up now. 1-for-15 against Southern Maryland last series, but that one coming as a home run.
The next pitch, outside, 1-1. The Revolution have certainly made one, with Andy Etchebarren leading the way. Some of the worst years in York Revolution baseball were well before Etchebarren got to the Central Pennsylvania. Here's the pitch is lifted to right field, handling the baseball and making the catch. Prentice Redmond, he was playing shallow for out two. Etchebarren won two championships in his first 2 years at the helm with the Revs. And in his first year, he won the first half and wound up having such a bad record in the second half, the team finished under 500.
But that's the key, especially in these leagues. Winning the first half guarantee you a spot into the playoff round.
And it makes things much easier, if you will, as the two-out toss is a fastball in the outside corner. No balls and one strike. For a whole number of reasons. One is more time for tickets to be sold for the postseason, so that way people know, hey, the team's in the postseason. Another reason is if the team knows it's in the postseason, they could naturally work on other fundamentals to the game, because by the 70-game mark, a lot of the teams have already decided what players they're going to pick up for affiliated organizations. The next pitch is inside, 1-1.
Exactly. You might not have the same team, actually guaranteed not to have the same team that you started the season with.
And another factor is the Mexican League. They end July, August area, depending on postseason and all of that. So some of those players might be picked up in affiliate, which limits this independent league even more as the pitch is outside, 2-1.
And as you mentioned, last year, York winning the title. This season, they got off to a 3-10 start, but kind of righting the ship now, 8-7 over the last 15.
Darrell Henry, the York Revolution broadcaster, brought up that point before. The 2-1 is outside, 3-1. The pitching has been better. The offense has been producing a little bit more. And if York can continue to improve, they have all the pieces that they need in order to win, with the exception of Jose Herrera from a year ago. The 3-1 is inside for 4, as Danny Gonzalez takes his base with a walk.
And last year, 16, dating back to their title run, they had a stretch in the first half of the year where they went 7-14.
Yes, they did. But they also recovered because their offense got in the groove. And you never know when this bunch is going to strike. They've never been a great road team, always dominant at home, and it reflects on the record that the Revolution have against the Bluefish at Sovereign Bank Stadium. The first pitch is inside, 1-0. We are in the top of the fifth inning. Two men out. Bridgeport and York have yet to score. Travis Scott is 0-1 today. He's popped out to the shortstop. The next pitch is slapped down the left field line. Lopez chases for a moment, but watches it go foul toward the bullpen. 1-1.
Stoner getting off the hill a little bit. They were working on it in between innings to see how he's reacting here. It's been rather smooth, but that last batter, Gonzalez, with the 5-pitch walk.
The 1-1 on its way from the right-hander. Stoner deals, pitch, swung on and served high in the air down the right field line. Prentice Redmond chasing after it towards the Bluefish bullpen, but he cannot get there. It lands in the bullpen about 3 to 4 feet away from the charging Redmond.
Redmond definitely had a beat on that ball, and if it wasn't for the exact placement of that ball where it landed on the mound, I think Redmond would have came up with it. that little hill that he had to kind of climb over ended up being the problem for him.
One ball and two strikes. We'll provide you with the trivia question courtesy of the York Revolution. The trivia question is, on this date, which pitcher drove from Florida to make his debut in Southern Maryland on this night? The 1-2, runner goes, pitches inside, the throw to second, not in time. That had to sting Eddie Rogers. It was a bounce off the grass, ricocheted off the heel of his glove, and then hit him in the chest. That deflection hurts hockey goaltenders, I'm sure. With less padding on baseball players, it's got to sting.
It was a good time for a stolen base there from Danny Gonzalez in the Revolution. Caught Bridgeport off guard. You could see Luis Rodriguez really wasn't prepared to be throwing down to second, and he kind of threw it loosely.
The 2-2 from the righty. Pitch. Another high fly to shallow left center field, but Kennard Jones calls off Elliot Ayala and makes the play for the final out of the inning. An F8 to retire the side. The Bluefish give up another three fly ball outs.
T-shirts.
One base runner left on. End of
T-shirts.
Four and a half. No score from Bridgeport. You're listening
t-shirt.
To Perry Miles and RJ Garcia here on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Come on, who wants a t-shirt?
Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I used to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
I called this one best girlfriend ever. It had been a long day and an even longer week, so I headed toward the kitchen, refreshment I did seek. But after swinging open the fridge, I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold beverage, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys, it was time to hit the store, but stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
A great performance so far for Toby Stoner. Has allowed two hits to the York Revolution. Meanwhile, Sean Hill's almost been equally as good, giving up one hit through the first four innings of work. Hill goes
number nine
in the fifth
with Luis Rodriguez,
Eddie Rogers, and Peter Barrows. 6, 7, and 8 in the order for the Fish as Rodriguez digs in. He is 0-4 on today. I was noticing during the break how many fly ball outs Toby Stoner was recording. There were a number of those. The first pitch on its way is a fastball in the outside corner. No balls and one strike.
They have been swinging high here. Now Luis Rodriguez stepping up for the Fish.
The next pitch is outside, one ball and one strike. The last eight outs that have been recorded have been in the air, whether it be on the infield or in the outfield. One ball, one strike, offering, swung on and missed. Rodriguez could not check his swing.
Rodriguez fooled there. Had a good series against the Ducks in Long Island. 4-for-11, couple runs scored, couple walks in three games. That was after sitting out some games with that hip flexor.
He bumped up his average, and he'll do so again with that single to left center field. He's on first base after he ripped one just to the left of second.
The Bluefish now with runners on board each of the last three innings. Double by Rogers in the third, a walk by Luis Lopez in the fourth, and now Luis Rodriguez leading off the inning with that single,
Eddie
up the middle.
Rogers.
Sean Hill has not gone more than four innings any time this year, although during his career he has done quite well, going to the big leagues and starting, going 5, 6, 7, 8 innings, even during that stretch. As the right-hander's in the stretch, elbows down, pitch on its way. Bunt is attempted, according to the home plate umpire Ronnie Whiting, as Rogers could not pull back in time.
I think Rogers almost started running down that line before he put that barrel on the ball.
One element that I noticed in batting practice, one of the players that was taking BP attempted the Ichiro-type swing, slug bunting out of the box towards third. The 0-1. Bunt popped up in the air and it bounces to first. Handled by Nowak, he flips to second where the shortstop Gonzalez is covering. The bunt was unsuccessful as it hung up in the air long enough to where Luis Rodriguez had to freeze for a moment. And as a result, he's eliminated from the base paths, a fielder's choice, 1-6. It brings up Peter Barrows.
Hitter number 32, Peter Barrows.
Ground ball to shorts to third base, his last at bat. Seems like he has a nice, smooth, compact swing to him.
Picked up a double yesterday against Long Island, two hits in the first two games of his Bluefish career. He's 0-1 today. The setup is outside from the catcher, Travis Scott, and then he throws to first after the pitch landed outside. The throw was not in time. It was an excellent throw right to the bag, about 6 inches over it, which is about where it should be.
It was a great snap throw right there. Caught Eddie Rogers sleeping a little bit. Dove back just in the nick of time. It looked like he almost tagged the bag, and if it was his hand, he would have been out.
The 1-0 on its way. Right-hander deals. Pitch right over the outside corner, 1-1.
That had some nasty stuff on it there. Broke across the plate and just kind of nips the corner on the way by.
Every pitcher in this league seems to have a wrinkle or two that forces the hitter to think twice. The runner bluffs going and Barrow swings through. 1-2. There may have been a hit and run on, but Eddie Rogers felt he may not have gotten the appropriate jump, and Barrow swung through. Rogers goes. He's dead at second.
It's maybe a blessing in disguise here, trying to stay out of that double play.
1-2, throw to first and on time. What you notice about Barrows, if you watch closely, he has that open stance, but his bat tilts more upward early in the count. When it's late in the count, he brings the bat more downward so that way he can shorten his stroke and make it more compact. It's a little bit further down the shoulder than one would expect. The 1-2, outside 2-2. And maybe he does not notice it, but it's evident from the press box.
If you got quick hands, you got quick hands, you know, and that's the key to any swing. You can have all the power you can have, but if you can't get your hands through the zone quick enough, then you're going to struggle at the dish. And it seems like he you know, whatever's comfortable, you see the most awkward batting stances.
It's all about establishing the fastball to throw for strikes. The 2-2 is a check swing foul. 3-2.
Could be a good time for Rogers to take off, hit and run. Maybe not a hit and run, but definitely trying to avoid that double play ball. Barrows is probably going to see a strike here.
3-2, 1 man out. Bottom of the 5th inning. Infield playing double play depth, especially up the middle. On the corners they're in towards the bag, and the first baseman Nowak holding the runner on. The next pitch twists outside. And the count at 3-2.
Looks like the line scorer might have had it wrong for us there. Thought there was 3 prior, but now the full count.
3-2. Barrows waits. He's worked the count so far. Set up his inside pitch. Chopped on the ground, foul to the third base side.
And there was Rogers taking off there.
It is not mandatory that a player take off with one man out or with nobody out. But if contact is made on the ground, runner from first is obligated to move over to second base to try to avoid a fielder's choice or potentially use a takeout slide for a double play. Three balls and two strikes with one man out. Another throw to first as Eddie Rogers has decent speed over at the bag. The right-hander just wants to make sure he doesn't get a big jump.
And, you know, it's a pretty common trend. You dictate the speed and rush the defense, good things will happen offensively.
Runner goes, pitches outside for ball four. Peter Barrows walks for the first time in this game. And it sets up runners at first and second for Elliot Ayala. And a quick visit from Mark Mason as there is action brewing down the left field line for the York Revolution.
First time the Bluefish have gotten multiple runners on in an inning. And talking to Terry McGriff, like I said, this is where the Fish need to come up with that solid hit. It's not that they're not getting runners on, base runners either by walks or fielder's choice or hits or whatever it might be, but it's coming up with that critical hit in a time of need. And right now in a 0-0 game, bottom of the fifth, this time couldn't be any better.
It could only be one of two choices out there in the bullpen. It's either Junior Novoa or James Hauser. It is Novoa. Left-handed pitcher. There are two members of the bullpen for the Revolution who are left-handed pitchers. Hauser and Novoa. Jesus Sanchez has been a starter on this team for the Revs, so he would be eliminated. Ryan Firebend and Chris Cody, also left-handed tossers, as the first left pitch from the righty, Sean Hill, stays high. One ball and no strikes.
Ayala with that little compact batting stance coming in at 5'6". Harder to throw strikes against him. You see a lot of pitchers missing high with shorter batters.
The 1-0 on its way from the righty. Glove set, elbows down, 1-0. Slides right to the outside corner, one ball and one strike.
Nice pitch by Hill right there, and he's going to need a good couple pitches to get him out of this inning. One down, 1-1 count now, and the top of the lineup waiting on deck in Kennard Jones.
Elliot Ayala, a New York City product, played in the PSAL. The 1-1 bends on the inside and close to the outside. One ball, two strikes. It had some strange movement there.
Another good pitch, two in a row by Hill. He's got Ayala off balance throwing that curveball for strikes, and from what I remember, that's been Hill's go-to bread and butter.
The 1-2, chopped on the ground to the third base side, but kicks foul, one ball and two strikes.
Staying alive swing there.
Junior Novoa has had started earlier in the year, but the Bridgeport squad rocked him, and many other teams took advantage of his inability to command his pitches. Not necessarily get ahead, but command them. There is a difference, which is why they brought in the right-hander Hill. The 1-2, swung on in line, base hit, left field. Rounding third, but stopping there, Eddie Rogers, Luis Rodriguez, or so. And I was right the first time, Eddie Rogers stops at third, single for Elliot Ayala to set the bases loaded.
Going to bring Kennard Jones up to the dish. Speaking with him earlier, he's been a bit frustrated with his production at the plate. A lot of moving parts now, and he's had to assume more of a leadership role. But on the other side of things, I think he naturally embraces a leadership role. He's a very vocal guy.
And so is Mark Mason. He makes his way to the mound for the second time in the game. He feels this is a critical moment of the contest as this call to the bullpen is made. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Junior Novoa coming from the York Revolution bullpen with the bases loaded. 4 1/3 innings of work for Sean Hill, the longest stint of the season for the Revolution pitcher. All three base runners are his responsibility when we return on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team?
At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. You're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you listen to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
We are back from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Junior Novoa is on the hill for the Revolution. And he has made a couple of changes, one of which is that he was displaced from the starting rotation and placed in the bullpen. But another thing is his ERA is significantly lower, and it's possible that there was a little bit of work done between Mark Mason and the left-hander that's currently on the mound. 5.87, no wins and three losses on the year. 23 innings pitched, but opponents still hitting a whopping 298 against the left-hander. He settles in on the mound. 4 1/3 innings officially for Sean Hill as the lefty is set at the chest. The Revolution hoping for the double play. The first pitch lands high, one ball and no strikes.
And as I was saying earlier, he's got a tough batter to face to start off. Lefty-lefty combo, Kennard Jones.
Jones tonight, 0-4-2, the 1-0. Fastball again high, two balls and no strikes.
But you know, as I was speaking to Kennard about his mini slump that he's been going through, still batting 311, but over the last 10 games, hitting just 227.
The 2-0 on its way from Navarro, swung on and missed, a big cut, two balls and one strike.
But he forever stays positive, Perry. This guy, he always knows that it's going to be a brighter day. There's another at bat, and he told me you can always take a positive from a negative every time.
Two balls and one strike. Setup is outside, pitch on its way, swung on and served foul to the left. Two balls and two strikes. One of the players that was aiming to get back to affiliate baseball was Ramon Vasquez, who retired today. And part of the reason that he may have is because he was hitting so well early in the year, but of late he had been scuffling at the plate, just 4 for his last 29. And perhaps at that point he said, you know what, I've been on 6 different major league teams. I've had 9 years in the big leagues. Maybe it's time that I decide to hang out with my family. The 2-2 is swung on and missed, strike three. Kennard Jones goes down for the second out of the frame and brings up Pedro Lopez.
He's got a heavy fastball there. That got up on Kennard quick, and you could feel it in the glove. I mean, I'm not actually catching it, but you can feel that heavy ball.
With two away, brings up Pedro Lopez. This has been the issue for Bridgeport over the last couple of games. One particular example from yesterday included when the Bluefish had runners at second and third in the third inning with nobody out. Both Kennard Jones and Pedro Lopez struck out. Eventually, the third out was recorded through Prentice Redmond. The two-out toss is lifted foul down the right field line. No balls in one strike. Early on against the River Sharks when the Bluefish were shut out 2 out of 3 games during the final stretch of that series, Bridgeport's problem was not getting runners on, it was bringing them in.
And that's the way it's been all year, is stringing them hits together when they count and getting them to plate.
You mentioned earlier, 7.5 runs a game when the Bluefish have won. The 0-1, fastball outside, one ball and one strike. More of a hitter's league. The hitters seem to be a little bit further ahead than the pitchers are. Just take a look at the total batting averages at this point for Long Island and Lancaster. They've been two awesome offensive teams. The 1-1 swung on and lifted foul down the right side. One ball and two strikes.
And this was a strategical move. Not only were you getting that matchup lefty-lefty when Kennard Jones was up to the dish, but getting through him now to Pedro Lopez, who's only batting .148 against left-handed pitching this season.
That is unusual. There could be any one of a number of explanations for that. But we do not have one for Lopez, other than the fact that he's dealing with a sore hand at this point. The 1-2 is a curveball that hits the outside corner. He spikes the helmet to the left of the umpire, and he is frustrated. The Bluefish are out of the inning as Willie Upshaw contends to Ronnie Whiting that that should not have been called. Two consecutive strikeouts for the Bluefish to end the inning. Lopez did not get tossed. A lot of patience from Ronnie Whiting. No runs in the frame on two base hits. Three are stranded. End of five. Bridgeport and York are still scoreless. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Entitled Coors Light Summer. It's a Coors Light Summer, hot babes all around. Backyard barbecues are where you'll be found. It gets pretty hot out, but it'll be all right because coolers are filled with ice cold Coors Light. You step outside, mini skirts galore. Beer garden for the ball game, that's what's in store. It's going to be a scorcher, but there's hope in sight. Refreshment awaits, Frost Brewed Coors Light.
Thank you. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I call this little ditty America's pastime. Summer's here and it feels pretty nice. Baseball and hot dogs and refreshment on ice. Some games are early, some are at night. But there's always a beer man with ice cold Coors Light. He's the most reliable player in the game. All it takes is calling his name. So even if your team doesn't hit any dingers, you'll have Frost Brewed Refreshment at the tips of your fingers. Thank you.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Gotta get dead. Gotta get dead. Gotta get dead. Gotta get dead, 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 dead. Gotta get dead. Gotta get dead.
The Bluefish have not been able to boom anything out of the ballpark today. Neither is York. No score. Top half of the sixth inning. As York is sending Brandon Hoffman to the plate. He's followed by Lou Rodriguez. And Ramon Castro. 1, 2, and 3 in the order. Brandon Hoffman was very surprised last year about his trek through the minor leagues. The first pitch is a check swing through the zone. No balls and one strike. Hoffman made a trip to Tacoma last year, the AAA affiliate of the Seattle Mariners. He was a mid-round pick, 29th overall, as the pitches swung on and missed. No balls, two strikes. 29th round pick as opposed to the 29th overall. Even though he helped Purdue to win back-to-back Big Ten conference titles. The pitch is chopped to the right side, handled by Pedro Lopez. He snaps the throw at first in time. One away.
Nice to see Pedro Lopez collect himself there. Frustrated after that last at-bat, especially with the bases loaded. And that's the toughest part about being a baseball player is clearing your memory from what had just happened because there's another play to be made.
And that's what the baseball players have to do. If they take their offensive struggles to the field, it may not lead to any team victory. As the first pitch is outside, one ball, no strikes. He could have easily bobbled the ball. Next thing you know, a double, scores the run. York wins the game 1-0. Pitches line, base hit over the leap of Pedro Lopez. The first base hit of the game for Lou Rodriguez, the third base hit of the day, and the second time that Rodriguez has been on tonight.
You know, the key is mental errors, mental mistakes. And you mentioned it, managers, coaches, whoever, players, they can live with a physical mistake when it just doesn't add up. But if you're not there mentally and screw up, I think that wears a little bit more in the long run.
The one-out offering on its way from the righty, but first, a throw to first. The trivia question for tonight was an interesting one. On this date, the Revolution played against the Southern Maryland Blue Cranes. The one-out toss is over the outside corner, about thigh high. No balls, one strike. Which member of the Revolution made his debut who drove all the way from Florida to Southern Maryland that night? Pitched that night. Cannot imagine how that person performed as the 0-1 is inside. One ball and one strike. Driving from where he was in Florida, the northernmost part, Jacksonville, or that area, is probably 10 hours away from Waldorf. Maybe even longer than that.
That's a long ride.
And then if you go even further south to Miami, add another 6 hours to that. The 1-1, the throw to first again, is not in time. He had to have left in the wee hours of the morning or the night before just to make it to Southern Maryland, assuming it was a 7:05 game. I've not seen too many Bluefish players do that. Drive all the way from, let's say, North Carolina and play that same day. The 1-1 swung on and fouled off. One ball, two strikes. Sometimes they'll be given the day off that day to recuperate, rest it off, and then come back the next day to perform. One ball, two strikes, one man out.
Baseball is forever the journeyman sport, though.
It is. All these players have been in a number of locations during their career. Single A, double A, triple A, the major leagues. We're not forgetting about rookie baseball irons. As 1-2 is sent foul to the right. That's only affiliated baseball. What about unaffiliated with the Mexican League and other independent leagues? Let's not forget about Taiwan, China, Korea, Japan, which are great leagues to be in.
Different atmosphere there, but great leagues nonetheless. Baseball is baseball.
1-2. Chopped on the ground towards third. They went past Lopez Rogers Fields and cannot get the short way at second. It's going to be ruled as an infield single. As Ramon Castro reaches first, the attempt was at second base. There was no shot to get Lou Rodriguez at second, and there was even less of a shot to get Castro at first.
And with that, Castro extends his hitting streak to now 7 games, as it makes him 1-for-3 this evening.
Right fielder number 9.
The Bluefish's Prentice Redman was riding a 27-game on-base streak, and he's hoping for 28, but so far, no dice. Well, one out, toss on its way from Stoner. Pitch swung on and served into right center field. It drops in for a base hit. The first run of the ball game will score for the Revolution as the second runner's being waved home. The throw comes in towards third base. It is up the third base line. It is a 2-run triple for Michael Hernandez to the opposite field. Lou Rodriguez and Ramon Castro both score, and the Revolution own a 2-0 lead.
Tough break for Toby Stoner there. Hernandez put a good swing on that bat and exactly right center gap and just roped one.
That pitch was smacked to the gap. Nothing that Jones or Redman could do. Plenty of speed out there in the outfield. It only came down, though, to the ability for the Bluefish to get to the baseball when they did, as the throw from Pedro Lopez from second to third was a little bit off the mark. The first pitch is inside, one ball and no strikes.
Still no action from the Bluefish bullpen, which goes to show you that Stoner really is pitching well.
The 1-0, high pop to shallow right center field. Kennard Jones moves over, makes the catch, tagging and bluffing, going halfway, the base runner Michael Hernandez, but he was stopped as Kadar Jones made a good throw to the plate.
I don't know, that bluff, it might have rewarded him for being aggressive there. That throw looked to be a little high coming in. It was going to be a bang-bang, but he might have been able to get underneath that tag.
The crowd chanting 0-4-3. But Michael Hernandez was on base. Chris Nowak, yes, is 0-4-3. After that fly ball caught by the center fielder. The next pitch is lifted down the left field line. charge sent towards the corner, but it goes into foul ground right near where the hot tub is located. No balls and one strike.
And here's Bobby Kelty. And how cool is it that he had a one-pitch home run in his only World Series at bat in his career?
And who did he hit it for?
The Boston Red Sox, when they went on to sweep the Colorado Rockies. Ended up being the game-winning run.
The 0-1 is lifted foul. No balls and two strikes. They won two World Series. The first one most Yankee fans will want to forget. And the second one most Rockies fans were glad that the team was even there. The 0-2. Grounded sharply towards first. Snagged down by Peterson, but the run does not score as the throw to first is in plenty of time for the final out of the inning. Beautiful play by Peterson as he dove towards the first baseline and was able to deliver a clean underhand toss to Toby Stoner for out number three. Michael Hernandez stranded at third, but two runs score on three hits. End of 5.5, 2-0, Bridgeport trails. You're listening to Perry Miles and RJ Garcia here on BridgeportBluefish.com.
We believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team with a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite? Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile. Only from AT&T.
Bluefish baseball is back in the bottom half of the sixth inning. The first pitch is outside, one ball and no strikes. For more information about Bluefish baseball, go to the website, BridgeportBluefish.com, where you can also follow the live stream today. The 1-0 is sky in the air to shallow right center field. The second baseman, Lou Rodriguez, backs up and makes the play for the first out of the bottom of the sixth. The out recorded by Prentice Redmond, who is now 0-3 on the night.
He's going to need another at-bat to keep his on-base streak alive.
More importantly, he may need to come up in a big situation when the Bluefish might be trailing. The offense certainly lost some of its punch with Joey Gathright and Colin DeLome departing. Let's not forget about Ramon Vasquez, because he used to supply some contact hitting on this squad. The one-out pitch is on the outside corner, no balls and one strike, and people could point out to 4-for-29. Before that, he was driving in runs, and he helped the Bluefish to get to that point. The 0-1 from Novoa pitch. Fastball races high. One ball and one strike. You can also follow me on Twitter. Just me, P. Miles. Just me, P. Miles on Twitter. Give you the latest updates, where to find the games. The 1-1 is inside, two balls and one strike.
Lopez, the patient batter, really dictating his own time. He's a veteran, 18th season of pro ball. 2,000 career pro hits, 1,000 career pro RBIs. He's got four straight years with 120-plus games.
Lots of durability for Lopez as he stares at a strike on the outside corner. Two balls and two strikes.
I mean, at age 38 this year, he's got four straight seasons with 120 games. I mean, he's got great shape, and he knows how to play the game.
The 2-2. Swung on in line off the glove of Novoa. It trickles into center field. A base hit for Lopez.
He's now 1-for-2 with a walk in that single. Good timely hitting there, especially in the meat of the order. Brock Peterson, Luis Rodriguez waiting on deck.
Brock Peterson is 0-for-2. A big home run to start off yesterday's scoring for the Bluefish. Got them out to the lead. It turned out they would need more than just his two-run drive. As Peterson steps forward, he's fouled out to first and flew out to center field in his two previous plate appearances. We're in the bottom of the sixth inning. Novoa twists his head around, and the first pitch is on the outside corner again. No balls and one strike. Every location seems to be on the outer edge. He never seems to go too far inside. There are some managers that encourage to go inside just so that way you could go further outside. The 0-1. Drops low, one ball and one strike.
It's a good block by Travis Scott behind the dish. It dipped in, now goes to 1-1 like you mentioned. And Peterson, he got off to kind of a slow start last season with Bridgeport as well and kind of started turning it on about this time of the year. And last series, is it, if that's any indication, this could be good signs to come for the meat of the order.
One ball, one strike. Righty in the batter's box. The 1-1 is high. Two balls and a strike.
You know, especially with the departure of DeLome, the Bluefish are going to need a power guy. They're going to need an RBI guy. They're going to need an extra base hit guy. And Peterson seems to fit that mold pretty easily.
Peterson can certainly drive the ball. He's had around 20 home runs during each of his professional seasons. That time he was not clubbing out of the yard. He had to try to check his swing, but he could not. High heat, two balls and two strikes. And here's the issue. The Bluefish have right-handed power hitters. Their issue is they do not have too many left-handed power bats. And if you look across the league, the best teams usually have a mixed of assortment of lefties and righties. As the next pitch is outside, three balls and two strikes. If you date back to 2010, the Bluefish had so many productive hitters, not just from the right side, but also from the left side.
But looking at Peterson in the last home series, he was hitting a lot of sharp ground balls and sharp line drives versus trying to lift the ball like he had done previously.
The 3-2. Another pop fly down the first base side. Nowak looks at it, but he's not getting there. Falls into the low seats. Three balls and two strikes. Just across the street, the Webster Bank Arena, I-95, deep into center field. Plenty of Memorial Day weekend traffic heading down from the shores and also from New England and from the south. Many people heading down to New York City. Why not to enjoy yourself? The 3-2 is grounded foul to the third base side. Three balls and two strikes.
Brock showing to be a tough at bat here, a tough out. He's not going down easy, and he's going to try to put this ball in play.
Brock Peterson had two plate appearances at Target Field in Minnesota when he was thought to be a top prospect by the Minnesota Twins. They brought him in there. Two plate appearances with the bases loaded, sacrifice fly and a single to center. The 3-2. Off-speed pitch just missed on the outside. Ball four. Could not tell why Ronnie Whiting called it a ball. Was it a little bit outside? Was it a tad high?
I think what happened there, Perry, is that curveball broke just a little bit later than his other ones had been. So when it got across the plate, it was a little bit high, but then it broke down, giving the illusion that it was a strike.
It is possible Ronnie Whiting has been consistent tonight behind the plate. The pitcher is certainly enjoying. The official score wants to give an official an error to the official.
Apparently he doesn't agree with the ump.
The one-out toss with runners at first and second. Luis Rodriguez stands in. First pitch, swing and a miss. 0-1.
Knew he was trying to get ahead there. Fastball was on its way, and Luis Rodriguez tried to jump the gun there and just a little bit behind on that. And this is going to be it. This is two straight innings now. Runners on base. The Bluefish need a hit.
0-1. Off-speed pitch settles low. One ball and one strike. Rodriguez 1-for-2 today with a single and a ground ball to short. 2-0 York.
We'll have to see on a base hit, see what Willie Upshaw is going to do with Luis Lopez at second base.
The next offering is low again. 2 balls and 1 strike. And sure enough, there is action in the York bullpen. Mark Mason seems to have the rhythm of his pitching staff down to a science. The 2-1 set up outside pitch is grounded to short. Could be two. Throw to second. Gonzalez one on the first double play. 6-4-3 DP for Luis Rodriguez. The Bluefish are done in the sixth. At the end of six, it is 2-0 York. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We also like to thank you for tuning in to today's stream. We will be right back after this.
Miller Time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller Time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk during your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller Time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Miller Time. It's a rallying cry to the men around you, the ones that have become your brothers. A call to beers answered with,
order me a Miller Lite, I'll be there in 10.
A night where your crew gets down to the task at hand that may or may not involve running tables,
oh, nice break,
firing up the grill,
oh, nice,
or getting the band back together.
Just
a few choice words spoken to the right men.
Yeah.
Men who crave a light beer that's never light on taste. Because it's not just a good time, it's Miller Time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
You, Kennard Jones, and Joey Gathright have been very good in the outfield. What kind of...
Hey, kids.
It's nice hanging out with some wings. That is our Buffalo Wild Wings.
Bluefish Baseball is here for the top half of inning 7. Let's take a quick look. If you had a question, comment, or concern about the Bluefish broadcast, send me an email to perrym86@gmail.com. perrym86@gmail.com. We will try to...
Left fielder number 12, James Shanks.
Respond to that as soon as possible. As the first pitch is on its way from the right-hander Toby Stoner, we'd like to thank everybody for hanging in there. The first pitch is squib foul to the right side. No balls and one strike. RJ Garcia is done for the night. He will be back tomorrow. No balls, one strike. Luis Lopez is at third base, hovering towards the line. The 0-1 from Stoner. Swung on and poked to shallow right center field. It is a base hit as Pedro Lopez left after he sprinted behind towards the alley but could not get there. It is a base
shortstop
hit for James Shanks.
Shortstop number 14, Danny Gonzalez.
His first hit of the night. And it brings up Danny Gonzalez. The question becomes, is there a bunt coming from Andy Etchebarren's ball club? You rarely see it, as there was a pitcher warming up in the bullpen for the Revolution. Could be Michael Nix. He is one of the setup men for the Revs. As the next pitch is low, 1-0. Michael Nix, RJ Rodriguez, the two players that have made significant impacts, but Nix is gone, so they've had to replace his services. 1-0 throw to first is not in time. Dumas Garcia is out of the bullpen. You also take a look at Adam Thomas, who was the closer in 2011 for the Road Warriors. I'm sure he will suffice for the Revs as the pitch is poked foul. One ball, one strike. Toby Stoner, this is the longest amount of work, longest amount of time that he has worked since he threw seven innings in his third start of the year. He had back-to-back seven-inning outings. Since then, it's been a struggle. The hit and run was on. The pitch is lifted into left field. Elliot Ayala charging, makes the play as the runner from first base, Shanks, has to move back to first quickly. With one man out, it sets up Travis Scott. The soccer fans, the baseball
catching
fans,
number 16,
still
Travis
out
Scott.
There on the right side. They are adamant fans. No matter what. These same people were here when the Bluefish were getting thumped against the Sugar Land Skeeters and still cheering even when the team was down by 14 runs. The one out toss is popped up to the left side. The shortstop, Eddie Rogers, angling towards the third base area and makes the play behind the third baseman Lopez at the lip for out number two. So Travis Scott comes up with a P6.
Number six, center fielder, Brandon
After
Hoffman.
Danny Gonzalez flew out to left and sets up Brandon Hoffman. Six hits for the Revs, two runs scored. Four hits for the Bluefish and no runs scored. The trivia question to today. There was a Revolution pitcher that drove from Florida to Southern Maryland for a contest that day, made his debut. Which pitcher was that? And the answer is Chris Ashby. Made his debut for the Revolution. That year, he set a league record 31-game hitting streak. The next pitch is outside, one ball and no strikes. 2008, that is what happened. Chris Ashby did quite well with York. The 1-0 dances low, two balls and no strikes. We are in the top half of the seventh inning. We will update you on any scores from around the Atlantic League and also the major leagues, especially Yankees, Mets, and Red Sox, as well as the NBA game taking place tonight between the Celtics and the Heat, game one from Miami. The 2-0, inside, three balls and no strikes. The Revolution at 11-17, the Bluefish at 16-14. Not division rivals in a sense, but these two teams competed a couple of years ago for the Atlantic League Championship, with York winning three games to Love. 3-0, fastball on the inside corner, 3-1. Speaking of Love, we're going to also talk about tennis. Love is the score when nobody is yet to score, usually 30 love, 40 love, 15 love. We'll talk about Federer, Nadal, and Djokovic. And perhaps go through the first round of men's and women's tennis action. Indianapolis was 500 was yesterday as well. Big weekend for sports. The 3-1 toss to first is not in time. And there was also a race at Charlotte Motor Speedway, although not nearly as important as the Indy 500. Two big races in motorsports, the Indy and the Daytona. Runner goes, the 3-1 is poked towards the middle and through towards center field for a base hit. Rounding second and moving towards third is James Shanks. He's there easily as he cruises to the bag. Brandon Hoffman with a single towards center. Runners
second
at the corners for
Lou Rodriguez
with two men out, as Kedar Jones, all he could do was play it into the second baseman Pedro Lopez on the relay. Lou Rodriguez, a single and a walk. As Toby Stoner is having a conversation with Louis Rodriguez and the first baseman Brock Peterson. He cannot afford to give up one more run in this game. The way that York has pitched today, with the arm of Sean Hill, followed by the piggyback of Junior Novoa, who will exit the game. Because whenever the Revolution get someone warmed up for a prolonged period of time, the inning before, the team has a philosophy they do not want to waste that pitcher. Stopping and starting the rhythm of a pitcher could get a baseball player hurt. The two-out pitch is over the middle at the knees. No balls in one strike. Think about it this way. If you go into a full force and then stop, full force and stop, it's going to be very taxing physically and mentally. It's a fake to third, throw to first is not in time. Wow. Brandon Hovind took a big lead after the bluff throw to third. Hovind's had to have seen that move before. He's been in pro ball for 4 years. The 0-1 throw to first, not in time. Took him 3 years to get to AAA. The age of 25 was in AAA before the Mariners decided to cut ties. The reason why a spot opened up for him, the outfielders on the Mariners were either ineffective or injured. The 0-1, fastball on the outside corner, no balls and two strikes. So Hyman got called a AAA, made a big jump from short season A to AA his first year out. Eventually worked in AA now, was in AAA last year. 0-2, another fake to third, fake to first, this time no throw. And the interesting thing about Hovman is he was the outfielder that was promoted and suddenly he's no longer on the Mariners. Sometimes it's a numbers game. Runner goes, the 0-2 is spoiled down the left field line out of play. No balls and two strikes. Bridgeport and York will meet 16 more times during the regular season. Each team plays one another 20 times during the year. No balls, two strikes, two men out. Glove at the chest, set, 0-2 again. Spoiled, this time further behind home plate. There are quite a few games taking place in the Atlantic League tonight. And we will go to that update in just a moment. As long as the inning continues. No balls, two strikes. Runners at the corners, 2-0 York. Even stance. Pitch swung on and line into deep right center field. Kennard Jones races back. He won't get there as he has to sprint to the wall just to get to it. Two more runs come to the plate this time on a Lou Rodriguez double to the deep part of right of center. Right near where the PC Richard and Son sign was. And the Bluefish are now down by a score of 4-0 with Willie Upshaw making his way to the mound and calling for the bullpen. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. We'll be back right after this with a runner at second base and two men out in the top half of inning number 7.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms? The pace of the game? The mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
Baseball is back. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Kyle Zaleski is on the hill. The right-handed pitcher has performed this year for the Fish very well. And he's one of the team leaders in ERA heading into today's action. Zaleski, 2 wins, no losses, an ERA of 3.26. 19 and a third innings tossed by the right-hander as opponents are hitting 289 against Zaleski. He'll have to deal with the likes of Ramon Castro, and if he gets on, potentially Michael Hernandez. There is no action down the right field line, but there is some, or there was some, down the left field area as the Revolution pitchers are ready to rear back and fire. They're ready to come into this game. The two-out toss to Castro is way inside and high. 1 ball and no strikes. It has turned out to be a beautiful night at the ballpark, with the exception of the way that the Bluefish have been unable to put a couple of runs on the board. The 1-0 swung on and missed. 1 ball and 1 strike. Toby Stoner was really good flying through today. Through the first 6 innings, just 2 earned runs, but he was asked to go 7, at least to complete 7. He just gave up the double to Lou Rodriguez, and it was too much. The 1-1 swung on and missed. 1 ball, 2 strikes. Unofficially for Stoner, 6 2/3 innings of baseball. 8 hits. The runner at second base is his responsibility, with the Fish down by a grand slam. Zaleski at the set, brings it down to the belt. The 1-2, chopped on the ground towards short. Eddie Rogers fields as he scampered to his right. He throws across in time to retire the side. 7th inning stretch time, Bluefish fans. Bridgeport trails 4-0. You're listening to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. We'll be right back.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community. The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
Advertising with the Bridgeport Bluefish is a sure way to hit a home run in your community. Since 1998, nearly 3 million fans have spun the turnstiles at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Supporting their local team and Fairfield County's local businesses sponsoring the Bluefish is just the right thing to take your business in the direction you want. The proof is in the numbers. More than 70% of Bluefish partners renew their sponsorships annually. And the best part is, there are tons of ways to get involved. Billboards, in-game promotions, giveaways, Fish Vision video board ads, radio spots, and much more. If the economy is sinking your business, it's time to get swimming with the Bluefish. To join the Bluefish team now, call any of our front office sales representatives at 203-345-4800 for more information.
Bluefish baseball is returning to the air for the bottom half of the 7th inning. Bridgeport down 4-0, courtesy of An two-run triple from Michael Hernandez to right center in the sixth, and a two-run double by Luis Rodriguez to the right of center in the seventh inning. And this call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. The first pitch is on the inside corner for a called strike. No balls and one strike. The pitcher is Dumont Garcia of Tallulah, Colombia. The 0-1 is grounded foul to the third base side. No balls and two strikes. He played with the York Revolution last year. Born in 1983, as he approaches 29 years of age, he'll be 29 in the month of July. No balls, two strikes. Garcia deals, swung on and missed. Eddie Rogers could not hold up as he becomes a strikeout victim of Garcia. The final line for Junior Novoa. Two and two-thirds innings. He allowed just one base hit, no runs across. And he right now stands to be the winning pitcher if York holds this lead or holds any lead without the Bluefish tying. The one-out toss from Garcia is a fastball sent high. One ball and no strikes. And Novoa struck out two big batters in his outing while walking one batter. The 1-0 swung on and poked to the netting. One ball and
pitching for York,
one strike.
Dumas Garcia.
Dumas Garcia has been okay this year. Hot and cold. High ERA and not too much of a sample size at this point. Eight innings pitch as the 1-1 floats away. Two balls and one strike. But Garcia's been hit around a little bit. 359. Opponent's batting average. The 2-1 from the right. He elbows down. He's set. Pitch. Another foul ball. Inside out swing from Peter Barrows, who's 0-1. Looking for his first hit at his home facility. Two balls, two strikes. Let's take a quick look at the Atlantic League scoreboard, courtesy of PointStreet.com and AtlanticLeague.com. And there's plenty of action tonight, including at Campbell's Field. The 2-2 in there, strike three. It appeared to be a floating changeup. Two strikeouts to start off the seventh for the second reliever of the Revolution. The Ducks lead the River Sharks by a score of 5-0 in the top of the seventh inning. The only other game taking place in the division, Southern Maryland and Sugarland, 3-1 the score. The Blue Crabs on top of the Skeeters from Houston. The two-out pitch is on the outside corner. No balls, one strike. York is wary about Somerset and Lancaster. Bottom of the seventh inning, no score in that one. A big-time pitcher's duel. The 0-1 swung on and poked out to right field. It is a base hit. Ayala is now 2-for-3 on the game as he stands at first base waiting for Kennard Jones to come to the plate. In that Somerset-Lancaster matchup, it is a pitcher's duel between Doug Arguello and J.D. Durbin. Arguello turned his season around to a degree against the Bluefish, and J.D. Durbin has been a solid contributor for Butch Hobson and company down in Lancaster. The two-out toss on its way from the right-hander. He stands tall and deals pitch right on the inside corner. It seems as if he's throwing more breaking pitches than fastballs to start off counts. And that may be a good sign because the Bluefish aggressively swing the bat at times. The 0-1, fastball inside as Jones had to jut out of the way. One ball and one strike. We'll also update you on the Major League Baseball scoreboard. Mets, Yankees, Red Sox. The 1-1 from the right-hander pitch. Well inside, two balls and one strike. The Yankees lead the Angels 1-0 in the top of the first inning. Runners at the corners for the Pinstripes. They've won, I want to say, 5 in a row. The Mets have also been hot. The 2-1, check swing, did not go through. The catcher, Travis Scott, hoping for a challenge. There is none given from home plate umpire Ronnie Whiting. 3 balls and a strike. The Mets get doubled up by the Philadelphia Phillies, 8-4 today from Citi Field. And there may not have, there's the Red Sox game. Pitch is swung on and lifted down the third base side, giving Chase Castro, and it is a foul ball that fell about 30 feet beyond his reach. He was about 20-25 feet to the left of the dugout in front of the tarp by the time the ball got to where the catchers would catch the ball on the leftmost point of the bullpen. 3 balls, 2 strikes. Red Sox 7, Detroit Tigers 4. What a disappointing season for the Tigers to this point. And they were expected to be one of the contenders, not only for a playoff spot, but also to go to the World Series, especially with Prince Fielder coming to Motown. The 3-2 runner goes, pitch, slap foul, and R. Jones stays alive. In the NBA, the Boston Celtics trailing the Miami Heat 28-17 in the second quarter. LeBron James and Dwayne Wade, I'm sure, are having field days at this point, running up and down the court the same way that a horse runs in a thoroughbred as the pitch is swung on the ground right back to the mound and throw to first in plenty of time for the out. Another scoreless frame for the York Revolution pitching staff at the end of 7. 4-0 the score. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training, rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team, including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish is running a Will Upshaw. Open 7 days a week, stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the Major League experience.
Bluefish baseball is back for inning number 8 from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Kyle Zaleski continuing the throw on the hill for the Bluefish. It is a 4-0 game. The Bluefish have been limited in the number of players that they've been able to use over the last few games. And as a result of Colin DeLome and Joey Gathright departing, there has been a little bit of a struggle on the offensive side.
Right fielder.
And Bridgeport is in danger of losing for the third straight game. They're down 4-0 heading to the 8th, as the first batter of the frame is Michael Hernandez. He steps in and takes a first pitch ball away. 1 ball and no strikes. Hernandez, Chris Nowak, and Bobby Kilty. 4, 5, and 6. Hernandez waits. The 1-0 is smacked into left field as a base hit between short and third. Fielding the ball in the corner outfield spot is Elliot Ayala as he relays to Eddie Rogers in line with second base. It is a leadoff single. Michael Hernandez is just one hit shy of the cycle. Of course, York would have to score one more time in order for that to happen, and he'd also have to get up one more time. The only thing that he's missing in his repertoire is for tonight is his home run ball. He has plenty of those this year. He has 8. It's a matter of whether or not he gets up in the ninth inning or even later in this frame. Next, Selesky pitches outside. 1 ball and no strikes. Nowak is 0-4-3. He reminds me of a left-handed hitter in the sense that he can hit the low and in pitches, just drop the hands down and whiff it down the left, rip it down the left field line. Pitches low, 2 balls and no strikes. He could just smack it down that way. And he's a right-handed hitter. Lefties, they drop the bat down, round the pole for the home run. Righties can do the same, especially the batter at the plate, 2-0. Appeared to be inside, 3 balls and no strikes. Four runs, 9 base hits, no runs and 5 base hits. Zaleski deals on the outside corner what appeared to be a slider. 3-1. Chris Nowak, already 2 home runs this year against the Fish. Number 3 would put his team up by 6. The 3-1 pop-up right side of the infield. Luis Rodriguez throws away his mask, and he makes the play on the cusp of the warning track on the right side. He came very close to the dirt.
Designated hitter number 32, Bobby Guilty.
And was able to make the catch just on the grass. Maybe 1 foot went onto the dirt. One away off the after the PF2. Brings in Bobby Guilty. He's 0-3 today. Strikeout in the second, a fly ball to center in the fifth. And a 3-1 ground out. In the sixth, left-handed batter with tremendous pop, which is why the Revolution picked him up. The pitch is lined in the right field, another base hit. Rounding second and trying for third. The throw on two relay is not in time. The throw was cut off initially. Michael Hernandez makes his way to third. Redmond threw the ball, I believe, to Pedro Lopez, who then delivered it to Luis Lopez, rather than Redmond throwing straight through. Outfielders are instructed, try to throw straight through. If the ball is not gonna quite get there in time, then the infielder is instructed to use instincts to be able to determine whether or not the ball is gonna get through 12, and catch the ball before shakes. The ball rolls all the way and a potential run scores. Of course, if the ball does go through, and the third baseman gets it in time, it's a great throw and a great decision made by the relay man. In that case, Pedro Lopez. One out pitch, swung on and missed. No balls and 1 strike. Let's take a look at the men's and women's tennis action, especially from Djokovic and Federer. Djokovic winning in straight sets. Federer did the same against unranked opponents. The 0-1 drops inside, 1 ball and 1 strike. And no Nadal playing today, at least for the time being, although he might play tomorrow. And it appears that the top-seeded Miss Azarenka has also moved on for the women's side. The 1-1 twists outside, 2 balls and 1 strike. French Open, 1 of 4 tennis tournaments, part of the majors. U.S. Open, Wimbledon, French, and the Australian. No such thing as a grand slam in baseball other than the 4-run home run. The 2-1, swung and lifted into right field. It is a base hit. Drops in front of Redmond. Another run scores. RBI single. Again by James Shanks. And the Bluefish now down 5-0. But there's no such thing as a tournament called a Grand Slam. There is the regionals in the College World Series, the super regional, the sub-regional. But no such thing as a Grand Slam in baseball unless you're talking about a home run. The one-out toss from Zaleski. Fastball inside corner strike. The ball's in one strike. It's been a pretty simple scoreboard to this point. The 0-1 is on the outside corner. No balls and two strikes. Two-run triple, Michael Hernandez. Two-run double, Lou Rodriguez. RBI single from James Shanks. Three sentences summarizes the scoring for today. And the Bluefish pitching has not gotten the job done in each of the last three innings. The 0-2. Off-speed pitch away. One ball and two strikes. Kyle Zaleski, a Midwest guy, state of Illinois. Lives in a suburb of Chicago, Mung Line, Illinois. The 1-2. Chopped on the ground towards first as Pearson corrals it in fair ground and runs to the bag for out number two. The runners move up a base with Kilty advancing to third and Shanks in scoring position at second.
16, Travis Scott.
Travis Scott has had an unsuccessful day against the Bluefish. Quite a few fly ball outs today. He stands in and waits for the first pitch from Zaleski. The two out toss, way high. One ball and no strikes. He released that pitch a little bit higher than expected. One ball and no strikes. With two men out. Zaleski's next offering, outside. Revolution of late have had more success at the ballpark at Arbor Yard than they ever have. And the reason being is because they've had many better hitters come to their cities. The pitch is grounded towards second, diving snag, but the only play that could be made is Pedro Lopez delivering the baseball to Eddie Rogers. He is slow to get up as it appears as if he may have gone on his injured hand. He's playing with a sore hand. He's walking slowly back to his base. But another run scores on an infield single,
center
this time
field, six,
from Travis Brandon Scott. Hassan. It is 6-0 York. Back-to-back-to-back crooked innings for the Revolution. Brandon Havman stares at a first pitch strike on the outer third. No balls, one strike. Havman a 2-for-4 day. Zaleski set the 0-1. Well outside, one ball, one strike. It's been that kind of day for the Bluefish. Offense has not gotten the job done. And York, third, fourth time around, able to hit. Pitch popped up to left field and charging forward to Eliana. He dives. And did he make the catch? He did not make the catch. Luis Lopez has the other lead runner in the rundown. A run scores on the play. And the tag is made. But not before another run comes plateward as James Shanks scores and Travis Scott caught in the rundown on a single by Brandon Havman. The inning ends with that rundown. It is 7-0, York on top after three runs had come to the plate in the top half of the eighth. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Third baseline with Brian from New Jersey, Joe and
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Celebrate the game. Celebrate the passion.
Baseball is different in a lot of ways, where the history of the sport means so much. And it's something we should never, you know, never forget. And I think the Hall of Fame has a way of reminding us.
Anytime that I've visited it, just I'm like a little kid.
You people at the Hall of Fame have done a great job of preserving the history of the game.
Celebrate the game. Celebrate the passion. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special...
Bluefish Baseball going to the bottom of the eighth. They are down by seven, though, as Dumont Garcia sets it on the outside corner. No balls and one strike with a fastball. Second inning of work. Dumont may be in for the rest of the game. Bridgeport hoping for a rally. The 0-1. Fastball away. One ball, one strike. And it would take quite a bit for the Bluefish to come back in this game. Seven runs, 14 hits to no runs and five hits. Third baseman leaning in. The 1-1 is inside. Two balls and one strike. Ramon Castro has played well at third base. In 2010, he had one of the highest fielding percentages in the history of Atlantic League play for a third baseman. The next pitch is outside. Three balls and a strike. Lopez has not gotten on base today. The top three hitters in the Bluefish order, 0-4-10. Have not reached the 3-1. Fastball, high ball, 4. Pedro Lopez reaches for the first time today. On a walk, it brings up Prentice Redmond, whose 27-game on-base streak is on the line. And he's earned a hit in 24 of those games. Redmond stands in. Three home runs on the year, 18 RBI. As the first pitch to Redmond is a fastball away, one ball and no strikes. Luis Lopez is the last batter due up in the eighth inning for the Bluefish. And no action in the bullpen, which means Zaleski. Well, it appeared there was no action. Zaleski may throw the final inning, even though he did allow three runs to score in the eighth. Prentice Redmond stands in. The 1-0 on its way. Garcia delivers pitch right on the outside corner. One ball, one strike. Flag is still out in left field. Not much wind. Another set pitch. Grounded. Base hit to left field. 27-game on-base streak extends to 28. A single to left field in the eighth inning as Luis Lopez moves forward.
Third baseman, number 19.
The Bluefish have been deprived of offense over the last two-plus games, including this one against the Long Island Ducks. Bridgeport had not scored a whole lot in the third game. They scored 5 runs in game 3 and just a few runs yesterday. 3 runs. Next pitch, fastball in the outside corner. No balls and 1 strike. You can hear the chants of "Let's go Bluefish" in the background from a number of the fans. The 0-1. Off-speed pitch outside. 1 ball and 1 strike. Lopez, a natural-born leader, has been on winning ball clubs, has earned a number of trophies in his career for MVP awards during All-Star games, MVPs. You name it, he's had it. Offers from countries whose names we cannot pronounce. The 1-1. Fastball away. 2 balls and 1 strike. And he's also had offers from countries whose names we can pronounce, like Mexico, Japan. He's been everywhere. The 2-1. Elbow set. Glove there. 2-1. Inside miss. 3 balls and 1 strike. That base hit by Prentice Redmond was only the 6th hit of the night. The 3-1. Fastball right down the middle. Another reliever throwing the bullpen, in all likelihood that is James Hauser, who's the other lefty in the pen. 3 left-handed starters. The Bluefish having all kinds of problems handling lefty relief pitching. 3-2, outside ball 4. Luis Lopez walks to set up Brock Peterson with the bases loaded and nobody out. And that means more visitation from Mark Mason, and he has decided that this is enough for his second relief pitcher of the game. The night is over for Dumas Garcia. He lasts an inning. The 3 runners on base are his responsibility. The Bluefish are trailing 7-0. We'll be back right after this with facts about James Hauser. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for our community.
Do you love baseball? Is it the uniforms? The pace of the game? The mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community. The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
All summer long on BridgeportBluefish.com. Stream games at home, courtesy of BridgeportBluefish.com as well. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. James Hauser is on the hill, the veteran relief pitcher out of Sarasota, Florida.
First baseman, number 23,
as he enters a game with some not so wonderful statistics. 10 and a third innings pitched, a 6.97 ERA. An opponent's hitting 302 against him. He gets roughed up a bit. And let's not forget, 13 hits in 10 and a third, two home runs allowed by Hauser. He stares in for the sign, glove settles at the shoulder. The first pitch is a fastball in the outside corner, no balls and one strike. It seems as if Mark Mason is not going to take a chance at keeping his pitchers in too long to instill confidence in his relievers, even the ones that have struggled. The 0-1, fastball away, one ball and one strike. This is a great scenario for Bridgeport, especially if they are able to come up with a base hit or even just keep the assembly line moving. Peterson's up, Luis Rodriguez is next. And Peterson has walked in three plate appearances. The 1-1 outside may have been a hair low. Two balls and one strike. 9:41 on the East Coast in the bottom of the eighth inning. York has scored seven runs in the last three frames after not scoring the first five. Two-one on its way from the southpaw. Pitch on its way, swung on and missed. Peterson expecting fastball. He was well out in front. Two balls, two strikes. Bridgeport hoping that this home stand, this mini home stand, treats them better the way that Southern Maryland and Sugar Land treat them. The 2-2 is swung on and missed. Strike three. Brock Peterson goes down with the strikeout, and it sets up Luis Rodriguez.
Catcher number 9, Luis Rodriguez.
Rodriguez is 1-4-3, a single, a double play ball, 6-4-3, and a 6-3 ground ball out. Bluefish need to put a dent into this in order to even consider coming back in this game. Rodriguez waits, the 1-out toss. Popped up in the air, foul down the right field line, shoots out of play, 0-1. Not much wind at this point at the ballpark. In left field, the flag is still on the American flagpole. And even the press box feels it has gotten a little bit warmer. The 0-1. Off speed outside, 1-1. Hauser, but a veteran of double-A baseball for quite some time. And he's made it to the big leagues in his career. The 1-1 swung on and missed. Another big cut from Rodriguez, a ball and two strikes. There is action brewing in the Bluefish bullpen as Joe Bateman will appear for Bridgeport in the next inning to try to hold the disadvantage for the Bluefish at a certain number, depending on what that number is, after this inning. One ball and two strikes. James Shanks well out in left field. There is no such thing as a no doubles defense in this inning. Just playing straight up, the 1-2. Fastball away, two balls, two strikes. Usually the no doubles defense is asserted or inserted, so that way Defense will not allow anything to go over their heads. It is much easier to catch the baseball when moving forward than it is when moving backward. We're trying to sprint back, especially when you have to look at the ball twitching your neck each time trying to find it. The 2-2. Swung on and served out to shallow left center field. On the move, diving and unable to make the catch. The throw comes to third. It is not in time as it is bobbled. It is an RBI single to shallow left by Luis Rodriguez. The shutout's been broken. The bases remain loaded for the Fish to set up Eddie Rogers. That was not a well hit ball. It was a well-placed baseball.
Shortstop number 24, Eddie Rogers.
Eddie Rogers with a double to left. A fielder's choice in the game. Hauser waits for a signal from battery mate Travis Scott, not mentioned about too much today. And usually when you do not mention about the catch too much, usually there are not too many base runners getting on. That would mean stolen base opportunities for the Fish. The one out toss swung on and popped up. Down the left field line, Ramon Castro going back. So is the shortstop, Danny Gonzalez, and he makes the play for out number two. The runners must move back. Peter Barrows perhaps represents the final chance for the Bluefish in this inning to at least scratch off a couple more runs in the lead. He's 0 for 2. The only RBI today for the Bluefish belongs to the runner at first base, Luis Rodriguez. The two-out toss on its way. Pitch. Another high fly to left center field, but playable for Hoffman, and he makes the catch in the alley for the final out of the eighth. A run does score to break the shutout on two hits, but Bridgeport still down by six. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Hey fans, turn your attention to the video board. One lucky fan is about to receive a special...
At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team with a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open a new Miller Lite Punch Top can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork. The lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with. Sorry, Alan. Drumsticks. Chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant. A motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. A spark plug. A domino. A house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened.
This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Joe Bateman is on the hill for the Fish. He's one of the league's leaders in games played this season as he goes for another appearance. And he is going to be in for game number 14 on the year, which leads the fisherman Jonah Bayless. Came into today with the most appearances in the league. Bateman this year's 19 and third innings. Opponents hitting 260 against the sidewinding righty. But his ERA is at 6.98. Bluefish pitching did not get the job done in each of the last three innings. The Bluefish scored one run on a Luis Rodriguez bloop single to left center, or to left field rather. And Bridgeport down 7-1 in the top of the ninth, as Luis Rodriguez, Ramon Castro, and Michael Hernandez make their way to the dish. The first pitch is on its way from the right-hander. Pitch on its way. Fastball on the outside corner. No balls and one strike. I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in tonight to the Bluefish broadcast. Perry Miles. And we do have a familiar fan out there who continues to post, who continues to root for the team that's opposing Bridgeport. That's not... Which fan are you, Tammy Lynn Stratton? The 0-1. On the outside corner, no balls and two strikes. Tammy Lynn Stratton, who is listening to the Bluefish and Blue Crabs last time that we were checking. It was the last series. This time around, she's watching the Bluefish and Revolution. She's rooting for the Revs. 0-2 is popped up behind home plate as Rodriguez throws his mask away, leans near the netting, but it falls a row or two behind in the seats. No balls, two strikes. The fog is beginning to set in to the Park City. You could see a glimmer of that on the right side of the field. Not too much of it. Not quite the way that it impacted the second game in Long Island, or for that matter, the way it impacted players at the ballpark at Harbor Yard during the last homestand. The 0-2 popped up. Left side of the infield. This time it's playable. Luis Lopez calls off Luis Rodriguez, and he makes the play for out number one. Ramon Castro moves forward. Castro, fly ball to center, fly ball to left. First, a single in the sixth, a quartered out in the seventh inning. Run scoring summary. Fifth inning, two-run triple, Michael Hernandez. Seventh inning, our two-run double from Lou Rodriguez. Similar parts of the ballpark to the right of center. In the eighth inning, three-run score, RBI, base hits, James Shanks, Travis Scott, and Brandon Hovman. The one-out pitch popped up. Shallow part of the outfield. The shortstop, Eddie Rogers, moves back. Now he moves to the infield and makes the play. The wind may have picked up for just a moment. Two outs in the frame. P6 for Castro.
Right fielder, number nine, Michael
sends
Hernandez.
Michael Hernandez. Hernandez was an all-star last year in the Atlantic League. With the Somerset Patriots, provide plenty of power. He's a very in high school. Graduate stands in. The two-out pitch is a fastball. In. One ball and no strikes. Baseball has become so competitive in the New York City area, especially with the arms that are coming through, the likes of Dellin Betances. Just one of those individuals. The 1-0 swung on and missed. One ball, one strike. Andres Perez, who's taking time off today. He's getting the day off. Went to Lehman High School in New York City. Luis Lopez, the third baseman for the Fish, attended Canarsie. So many New York roots through Major League Baseball and also in this league is the 1-1 is stroke foul, one ball and two strikes. Elliot Ayala from New York City as well. It's almost as if players wanted to grow up in that neck of the woods, competed, and eventually made it as that pitch is swung on and missed. That pitch was 5 feet outside the strike zone. Hernandez swung anyway for strike three. That ends the inning, but not before the Bluefish have to come up to the top of the ninth inning, down by six. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Looking for the ideal place to meet before or after a show, game, or dinner?
How about the perfect spot to unwind? Try the Blue Martini. Fairfield County's sophisticated gathering place in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. The atmosphere is pure and cosmopolitan. The light menu is as hip as the lounge itself. And our signature martinis, try it. The bartender hates you. You'll love it. Blue Martini, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. For 995 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking. Kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey, Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team, including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish is running a Will Upshaw. Open 7 days a week, stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, to get the major league experience.
Advertising with the Bridgeport Bluefish.
The Bluefish are down to their final three outs of the ball game with Elliot Ayala springing to the dish. It is Ayala, Kennard, Jones, and Pedro Lopez. The first pitch on its way from the right-hander is low. One strike. The count, actually, is it bent to the knee. James Hauser was out of the game. And it appears that there is a new pitcher. The pitch is grounded over towards first, handled by Chris Nowak. He steps to the bag, and there is one away. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. I believe it's number 27, Adam Thomas. We'll double check on that in just a moment here on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Center fielder number 17, Kennard Jones.
Kennard Jones steps forward. Adam Thomas has been nearly automatic. Ian Thomas went to Affiliated Baseballs. The next pitch, fastball low, one ball and no strikes. Adam Thomas did not play in organized baseball for 3 years, organized professional baseball for 3 years, until last season. The 1-0 outside, two balls, no strikes. Adam Thomas has struggled this year. One win, one loss, an ERA of 5.65. 14 and a third innings for the right-hander. Stands in the set, glove down to the belt. 2-0. Low 3-0. Last year he was dominant with the Road Warriors as their closer. The Atlantic League getting more accustomed to the way that he throws, and maybe the Atlantic League has caught up with him. 3-0 is right on the inside corner. Three balls and one strike. The best pitchers, they know how to make the secondary and tertiary adjustments, especially in year 2, 3, 4, etc. 3-1 is pounded up the middle. It's a base hit. Kennard Jones is 1-4-5 this evening as he reaches first base to spring Pedro Lopez to the dish. Toby Stoner, 6 2/3, eight hits, 4 runs, 2 walks, and a strikeout. Zaleski, an inning, a third, 5 hits, 3 runs, an inning for Bateman, and a strikeout. Adam Thomas is the 5th pitcher of the night for York, after Hauser and Garcia each worked an inning. An inning, 2/3 from Novoa and Hill, lasting 4 1/3. It is highly likely that Novoa would wind up as the winning pitcher. The first one is on the outside corner. No balls, one strike. Naval going in an inning of two-thirds. With Garcia and Hauser an inning apiece. And Thomas having recorded an out. Lopez stares at another pitch. This time it's low. One ball, one strike. Scattered hits throughout the lineup. Three of the Bluefish bats have yet to pick up a hit. A couple of multiple hit nights for Bridgeport. Luis Rodriguez, Elliot Ayala. The 1-1. Fastball over the middle, ball and two strikes. But none of those hits nor bases on balls have really equated to runs scoring. With Lopez, he's walked and scored a run. It counts for the only run of the night, the 1-2. Check swing, did not go around on an off-speed pitch, 2-2. The Bluefish will have another game tomorrow night at the ballpark at Harvard Yard. Gilbert DeLavaro, who's been one of the better Bluefish starters this year, 6 starts, 2-1, 4-0-8. Against Corey Thurman, who the Bluefish have had major struggles against, yet he's having an off season. The 2-2. Chopped on the ground to the right side. Handled by Lou Rodriguez. Flips the second one. Onto first. The ball game is over. And the Bluefish have lost by a score of 7-1 on the double play. A nice turn by Lou Rodriguez. The post game show comes to you right after this on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Thanks for coming out to the ballpark at Harvard Yard. We'll see you tomorrow night for game two.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Will Upshaw. Open 7 days a week, stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the major league experience.
Advertising with the Bridgeport Bluefish is a sure way to hit a home run in your community. Since 1998, nearly 3 million fans have spun the turnstiles at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Supporting their local team and Fairfield County's local businesses sponsoring the Bluefish is just the right thing to take your business in the direction you want. The proof is in the numbers. More than 70% of Bluefish partners renew their sponsorships annually. And the best part is, there are tons of ways to get involved. Billboards, in-game promotions, giveaways, Fish Vision video board ads, radio spots, and much more. If the economy is sinking your business, it's time to get swimming with the Bluefish. To join the Bluefish team now, call any of our front office sales representatives at 203-345-4800 for more information.
Bluefish baseball is back on the air. Perry Miles here. The final score from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. The Bridgeport Bluefish lose by a score of 7-1. Let's take a quick look as to what happened in this game today. The run scoring quickly. After five scoreless frames, sixth inning was the start of the pitching unraveling. Two-run triple by Michael Hernandez with runners on base to make it 2-0. A two-run double by Lou Rodriguez with two more runners on base to make it 4-0. In the eighth inning, RBI singles by James Shanks, Travis Scott, and Brandon Hovman to make it 7-0. Louis Rodriguez came up with an RBI single to left field to put the Bluefish on the board, but it was not enough for Bridgeport. Prentice Redmond came up with a single to left field in his final at-bat, and it extends his on-base streak to 28 consecutive games. 28 straight for Prentice Redmond tonight, and he'll go for 29 tomorrow. The final score from the ballpark at Harbor Yard, the York Revolution 7, Bridgeport Bluefish 1, 7 runs, 13 hits to 1 run and 8 base hits. No errors for either side. Hovman, 3 hits, a run at RBI. Lou Rodriguez, 2 hits and a run with 2 ribbies. A hit and a run from Castro. Hernandez, 3 hits, a run, 2 ribbies. Nothing from Nowak. Kilty with a hit and a run. 2 hits, 2 runs, and an RBI from Shanks. Nothing from Gonzalez. A hit and an RBI from Scott. Jones, a hit. Run from Lopez, Redmond, and Lopez, Luis Lopez, that is, with a hit each. Nothing from Peterson. 2 hits and an RBI from Louis Rodriguez. Eddie Rogers with a hit. Nothing from Barrows. And 2 hits from Elliot Ayala tonight for the 8 that is accounted for. Louis Rodriguez was involved in the game, but Lou Rodriguez is the one that wound up with a double. His first, Hernandez is 7th. Eddie Rogers is 6th. Triple from Michael Hernandez is 1st. And, of course, there were no home runs in the game. Stolen base from Gonzalez, his 3rd. York Revolution left 6 on Bridgeport with 10. There were a number of double play turns this evening, 2 of them coming from York and 1 of them from Bridgeport. Hill did not last long enough to factor in the decision. 4 1/3 innings of shutout baseball, 3 hits, 2 walks, and a strikeout. Junior Navoa, who crossed over into the 5th inning, and also through shutout baseball, picks up the victory. An inning and 2/3, a hit, a walk, and 2 Ks. Of course, if the relief pitcher relieves the starting pitcher, you do not have to cross over into the 5th inning. You could record a couple of outs and then leave, or just 1 out and leave. Whatever it is that the score describes as the victory, he does, and it's all about scorer's discretion. Dumas Garcia, an inning, 2 hits and a run, 2 walks and 2 strikeouts. Hauser with an inning and a hit with a strikeout. Adam Thomas, an inning and a hit overall. The bullpen was sharp, 4 2/3 of 1 earned run baseball. Toby Stoner lost, 6 2/3, 8 hits, 4 runs, 2 walks and 1 strikeout. Kyle Zaleski, an inning and 3rd, 5 hits, 3 runs allowed. Bateman with a scoreless 9th inning for Bridgeport. He struck out 1 batter. Strikeouts on the game, not too many. 6-4 York and 2-4 Bridgeport staff. Hernandez and Kilty with each. Kennard, Jones, Lopez, Redmond, Peterson, Eddie Rogers, and Peter Barrow scattered the strikeouts. 7 total walks, 5 allowed by York staff, 2 by Bridgeport's Lou Rodriguez and Danny Gonzalez with the walks for York. Pedro Lopez, 1-2 for Luis Lopez, Peterson, and Barrows each with 1. Time of the game, 2 hours and 15 minutes at the ballpark at Harbor Yard this evening. The game, 2 hours and 15 minutes. When we come back on the Bluefish broadcast, we will close out with some of the scores from around the Atlantic League and then the big league, the major league status of the Celtics and the Heat taking place also, the Yankees, the Mets, and the Red Sox all in action today. Stay tuned. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work.
from conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks. Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community. The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious 7-14, sovereign twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? We're taking away to the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot, and a beautiful renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street, in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take out only 5 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
If I die young, bury me inside. Bluefish Baseball is about to come to a close for the night, but before we do that, let's take a quick look at the scoreboard courtesy of PointStreak.com and AtlanticLeague.com. Quick updates as the Bluefish now are in all likelihood going to find themselves 4.5 behind Long Island, as the Ducks are leading the River Sharks 8-0. No score, top of the 10th inning from Lancaster. Somerset Patriots, Lancaster Barnstormers in a pitcher's duel. Meanwhile, the Sugar Land Skeeters took down the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs tonight at Constellation Field by a score of 5-4. And so with that said, there are going to be some interesting setups for tomorrow. Maybe not necessarily in the Liberty Division with Long Island moving up 4.5. But Southern Maryland and the Camden River Sharks, they're each going to be falling behind, especially Camden. Camden will be 7 back. Southern Maryland 6.5 back. Bridgeport 4.5 back in the Liberty. And it's almost conceivable to see that Camden may not make its way or even have a shot to win the division within the next few weeks. It's going to be rather difficult for Camden to make up that kind of ground with only 40 games remaining, 7 back already to the first 30 games. Meanwhile, in that Freedom Division, the Sugar Land Skeeters, their win today, they're a half game behind the Patriots and tied with Lancaster. Either way, they will be tied for second heading into tomorrow's action, because if Lancaster wins, they'll be ahead. If Somerset wins, the Patriots will be ahead of the Skeeters. And they could either be tied for second or in second place, depending on the result today. Either way, they're not going to take control over first, even though they have been the hottest team and potentially the best team over the last few weeks in the Atlantic League. Let's take a look quickly at the scores from around the world of Major League Athletics, courtesy of ESPN.com. The Miami Heat lead the Boston Celtics 55-52, almost midway through to the third quarter, 7:33 remaining in the quarter. In Major League Baseball, the Yankees and Angels are tied at 4 in the top of third with a runner at first. Philadelphia doubles up the New York Mets 8-4. And the Red Sox take down the Tigers by a score of 7-4. Other action taking place, 4-1 Texas on Seattle, middle of the seventh. The Milwaukee Brewers lead the LA Dodgers 3-1 in the bottom of the sixth. Houston and Colorado knotted at six. Bottom of the sixth, runners at first and third. Other scores, for the most part, actually for every part, are final. St. Louis 8 and Atlanta 2. Miami takes down Washington 5-3. Pittsburgh a 4-1 winner against Cincinnati. Minnesota 5 and Oakland 4. The Chicago Cubs 11. The San Diego Padres 7. Chicago White Sox edge the Tampa Bay Rays 2-1. Colorado a 9-7 winner against Houston. Cleveland beats Kansas City by 3, 8-5. San Francisco doubles up Arizona 4-2. And Toronto defeats Baltimore 6-2. Those are the finals in baseball. Meanwhile, in men's tennis, Novak Djokovic and Roger Federer advance on the men's side. Azarenka advances on the women's side along with Radwanska. Also, Let's not forget about Jared Weaver. He exited today's contest with a lower back injury, and that is a major problem as the Bluefish, they'll have to deal with other issues trying to get offense for tomorrow's game, just scoring one run on eight base hits. And they'll take on the York Revolution tomorrow. First pitch of 7:05 p.m. Gilbert De La Vara will be taking on Corey Thurman. Lefty has six starts, two wins and one loss, an ERA of 4.08. Against Corey Thurman, six starts, two and one, 6.38. For more information about Bluefish Baseball, go to the website, bridgeportbluefish.com. Or you can send me an email to perrym86@gmail.com. And you'll be able to follow me on Twitter, just me, P. Miles. Just me, P. Miles. The final score, the Bluefish fall 7-1 tonight. As the Bluefish fall to 7-7 at home, 14-13 in the month of May, 16-15 overall this season, and 2-2 against the York Revolution. We will see you for a 6:45 pregame show. Tuesday is Kids Eat Free, presented by Big Y World Class Market. For Perry Miles, we will see you tomorrow at 6:45 in the evening.